with their big win on the gridiron last Saturday against Auburn, and some of those fans bringing that enthusiasm into Stegman Coliseum for a little college basketball tonight as the Georgia Bulldogs get set to take on the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers out of the Sun Belt Conference. It's all coming your way right here on FSN. And hello again, everybody. I am Dave Neal alongside my partner Larry Conley. And Larry, as we embark on another college basketball season in the SEC, expectations are going to be lofty, especially after what happened last year. LSU and Florida in the Final Four with the Gators taking home the national title. That's a tough act to follow.
It's not often you and I have a chance to say in the preseason the Southeastern Conference is the number one basketball conference in the country, and it is. And we may be watching the surprise team in the SEC this year in Georgia, but watch out for Western Kentucky. This upstart club is very solid.
Part of the reason is because of their junior guard, Courtney Lee, averaged over 17 points a game a year ago.
Yeah, if you're going to draw up a guy that plays the wing position, this 6'5 youngster from Indianapolis is about as good as they come. He can do everything. Good offensively, good defensively, and can really rebound.
Well, this Georgia basketball team definitely needed some help on the inside, but where they don't need any help is out on the perimeter because they've got a load of talent coming back, including two guys we picked out.
Yeah, these two guys, looking at them right here, Sunday out of games, led this club in assists, steals, and get this, rebounding at 6'1". Billy Humphrey probably worked harder on his offensive game, more so than anybody on this Georgia squad this past summer.
Well, that paid off as he knocked down 7 of 8 field goals in Georgia's opener. Last year, this game went down to the wire in Bowling Green. What will happen now? Stay tuned and find out.
Not all the energy for our fuel comes from oil on the ground. A lot of it comes from our people, who year in and year out put so much of their energy into everything they do. So you can be sure that when you put Valero gas into your tank, you're going to get a lot out of it. Valero, the energy to take you anywhere. The Ford Fusion. Now available in street clothes, starting under 18 grand. Bold moves at your local Ford dealer.
Coming up on the next Around the South, the first place Hawks look to buck Milwaukee. We have got all the post-game coverage, plus getting a grip on the NBA's new basketballs. It's not as easy as you think. An Auburn linebacker who's not only a student athlete, but a teacher as well. And up close with the Thrashers, Ilya Kovalchuk. The man is fire on ice. On Around the South tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern Time.
Back in Athens, Georgia, Western Kentucky and the Bulldogs. Let's take a look at our Volkswagen starting lineups as the Dogs and the Hilltoppers get set to come your way right here on FSN South. And Larry, when you look at these lineups, what's a matchup we should keep an eye on tonight?
Well, I think the one that stands out to me is actually the Georgia Bulldogs Sunday out of games taking on the junior college transfer. The guy that I think may be the key to the Western Kentucky squad, Tyrone Brazelton. Two excellent guards.
It'll be an interesting matchup, and we'll see what transpires when we come back. Tip-off is on the way. Georgia and Western Kentucky from Athens. Stay with us.
How many fingers do you see? 23.
Chicago 23, New York 23, Rancho Cucamonga's 23.
Drop it, give me 23!
Only Dr. Pepper is made from 23 flavors. 23! For a taste so mind-blowing, it's all you can think about.
23. Over there.
The spider monkey is indigenous to...
23!
With 20... I think the first time they look at it, they do see a lot of buttons, you know, and most people just want to know how to turn things on and off. A lot of customers don't even realize that they can simply hit 99 and hit the OK button, go right to On Demand, and get to HBO and Showtime and see all their programs they like to see, like Sopranos and things like that. Everything in life can be complicated if you let it be. Depends on how you look at it. Simple is better, you know, and simple can be great.
I believe staying healthy is important.
I need to be responsible for myself and my family.
I want a place where I can learn from people like me.
Healthy Nation, the first independent network dedicated to healthy living. It's free, on demand, and easy to use, with explanations from real doctors, along with true life experiences from people just like you. Healthy Nation, always here, always independent. Available now on Channel 99 in the free spot.
Sarah on FSN.
You're watching FSN South.
Tonight's Western Kentucky Georgia basketball game is brought to you by Dodge, by Chevrolet, and by Southeast Toyota. We are back inside Stegman Coliseum here on the campus of the University of Georgia, Western Kentucky, and the Georgia Bulldogs. Game number three of this four-game series. 4 years, I guess I should say, a game every year. Part of the deal when Dennis Felton took the job as the head coach of the University of Georgia, playing his a program that got his name out there in the college ranks. Rashad Singleton wins the tip. Should come as no surprise. Rashad, the seven-footer, the sophomore.
There's that matchup out front. Gaines and Brazelton already going at each other.
Singleton extended off to Gaines. Inside to Steve Newman. His turnaround off the glass is good.
Well, that bodes well for Georgia if Newman is making shots like that. A nice little turnaround jumper down on the block. Yeah, we've got palming already.
I just, not 5 minutes ago, talked to Gary Maxwell and Rick Crawford and Jim Burr about that palming call, something that's a point of emphasis. And they said, you know, if we wanted to call it every time down the floor, we probably could. But when we see a player get a definite advantage, we will blow the whistle on it.
Dave, I think what's happening is in November and December, you're going to see a lot of that called. And maybe the players will make the adjustment as we get deeper into the season.
Nice look inside. Gaines finds Singleton, who lays it in up over the iron.
You know, I talked in the open about the fact that this Georgia club could be the surprise team in the SEC. It'll be because of plays like this that'll make them that way. How about Gaines getting that deep into the defense and finding a wide-open Rashad Singleton? I think he may be the most improved big guy in the conference this year in a league that is loaded with big people.
Here's Courtney Lee. Western Kentucky's first real offensive possession. Brazelton, the 5'11 junior college transfer, makes his home in Park Forest, Illinois. There's Lee, pull-up jumper is good. That's why there's about 10 NBA scouts in the building.
He's great at getting his shot off like that. I mean, he creates his shots. Even if they give him screens, he still is able to come up with that basketball and get a little creativity of his own. He's an excellent offensive player.
Here's Mike Mercer, the sophomore out of Snellville, Georgia. Gives it up to Terrence Woodbury. Back after battling injuries his freshman year. Here's Mercer. Woodbury will fire for three. Off the iron, no good. Rebound taken out of there by Daniel Emerson.
He's the workhorse for Western Kentucky down inside. He's the rebounder and a pretty good shooter.
Right on cue. Emerson knocks down the three. Not bad when you can get your 6'8", 230-pounder to start knocking down some threes.
Well, it's one of the part of his game that really has improved. He didn't do that much of it last year because as a freshman, you don't ask that much of your freshman anyway.
Nice little runner in the lane from Mercer, his first basket. And there, nearly a takeaway. It'll be Western Kentucky basketball as Mercer flips over the chairs. And that gets a round of applause from his head coach, Dennis Felton.
Folks, if you're sitting at home watching tonight, do not go away because this game will be up and down the court. Both of these clubs love the transition game. Nice move down in there by Mike Mercer in the lane.
And a hard foul underneath. That will send Brazelton to the free throw line. Talking to Darren Horn today, Larry, about his point guard and said that's really something that they didn't have a year ago, despite the fact that they won 23 games. They needed a true point guard, and that's what Brazelton gives them.
And Ty Rogers, a young man who will come off the bench later for Western Kentucky, was their point guard last year. But he was not accustomed to running a basketball team. He's mainly a shooting guard. Brazelton brings that ability to get deep into the defenses and be able to kick the ball out. He is an excellent passer. First-team junior college All-American.
Averaged 18 points. Had 158 assists last year. Also had 66 steals, 76 three-pointers made. That'll get you All-American honors. Foul on the floor on Gaines. Brazelton will pick up the personal. Larry Dennis Felton this has been a work in progress. He's known it since he took this job, but in talking to him today, he seems very excited about where this program is going.
Well, it's the first time he's had a full complement of players. I mean, they've had difficulties because of some probationary problems created by the previous regime, but no longer. He's got his full complement now, and he's ready to go out and play. I think they're going to have a very good year.
Of course, he spent some time at Western Kentucky, 5 years with the Hilltoppers, went 154, 100 games he won, 54 he dropped, included in that three NCAA tournament appearances. That jumper might have been nicked by Steve Newman. Here's Woodbury.
Woodbury's a little excuse me pass there. I think he wanted to pull that one back in. Oh, boy, that's excellent defense out there. Nicely played by Western Kentucky.
There's Courtney Lee causing some problems on the defensive end. It'll still be Georgia basketball. No change of possession, so 15 on the shot clock.
Now, Dave, consider this. We're talking about a Courtney Lee player who last year averaged, as you said, 17 points a game, maybe the best player in the Sun Belt Conference. Look at his defensive work. You usually don't get that from the best offensive player on your squad, if not the best offensive player in the Sun Belt Conference.
That's exactly what Darren Horn said, is that he's starting to understand this year to play defense on every possession, not every other possession. Newman's jumper, no good. And Woodbury strong to the basket, saw a seam and took advantage.
Find that opening, use it.
Boy, before you blink, Brazelton's at the other end of the floor. Blocked from behind and a traveling violation.
Let's go back and take a look again. You can see right there, good grab down in the corner, and of course Woodbury just finishes it off. A nice move over there to pick it up Dave Bliss to get it and get it to him as he made that cut right down the lane.
Already four different Bulldogs have scored as Georgia leads at 9-6. And a 5-second violation against Sundiata Gaines.
You know, we were talking earlier about Lee's ability to defend. How about the work that time by Tyrone Brazelton? Again, it's that matchup we talked about at the top of the show. These two guys are excellent guards.
Here's another good matchup right here, Mike Mercer and Courtney Lee.
Look at Lee go. Oh, good slap from behind.
Dennis Felton says Mike Mercer can be a defensive stopper, one of the better defensive players he has on his roster. Quick hands, quick feet. Asking a lot, though, checking Courtney Lee tonight.
Both of these clubs work extensively on half court and full court zone pressure. Neither club has used that at least to this point.
And Brazelton will pick up his second foul. That was kind of a chippy out there around midcourt. And that'll get Orlando Mendez Valdez on the floor. And Brazelton will have to take a seat with two fouls. Will that sit him down for the rest of the half, you think?
Well, I don't know. You know, every coach has a different philosophy about that. A number of them, if you get two fouls in the first half, you don't get back in. I'm not sure what Darren Horn's philosophy is about that, but you know what? He may need Brazelton to get back out there because you don't want to let this game get out of hand early. Right now, Georgia leads by three, but you know, Western Kentucky seems to be in pretty good shape. This kid's not a bad point guard out there, certainly not as good as Brazelton.
Mendez Valdez, a sophomore out of San Antonio. Here's Mercer. That won't go down. Batted around. Georgia had a couple of chances. Last year was pretty much one and done for the Dogs.
Well, that's a big lineup with Jackson and Singleton out there.
And a hold underneath. That'll go against Albert Jackson, the freshman. Timeout on the floor. Georgia leads it by three.
ATL, retuned. Introducing the high-performance TL Type S. Acura. Advance.
Here's my crystal story about the steamer challenge. We live about 3 minutes away from a crystals.
Hey guys.
You divide a steamer 12 on 12. You got 3 minutes to eat all 12.
Go.
But if you don't, you gotta buy next time. So it gets pretty competitive. Hitting each other, punching each other, anything to mess up their rhythm. This guy could beat Kobayashi. He's kind of like a python. He can unlock his jaw.
Don't champion.
That's our crystal story, and we dare you to top it.
This holiday season, leave the perfect hint for your wish list. Dreams come true during the Lincoln Mercury Wish List event. Featuring the new Lincoln MKZ, 263 horsepower, all-wheel drive, and award-winning interior. All wrapped up in one luxurious package. Open one up for yourself with zero cash due at signing and only $399 a month. Find the ultimate holiday gift during the Lincoln Mercury Wish List event.
You're watching FSN South.
The Georgia Bulldogs lead Western Kentucky by three. 15:48 to go here in the opening half. Darren Horn's Western Kentucky Hilltoppers just missed out on an NCAA tournament appearance last year. They lost in the Sun Belt Tournament Championship game. They did win the regular season, but a good season nonetheless. And Larry, as we found out, they were actually the 66th team in terms of getting into the NCAA tournament. Of course, only 65 get to go.
I know Darren and his fans were very disappointed they didn't get in the tournament last year. In fact, they actually lost to South Carolina, who won the NIT last year for the second time in a row. He felt like he could play a lot better if he had him at his place.
Western Kentucky with three straight turnovers. Billy Humphrey checks in, gets it inside to Singleton. He's double-teamed, his hook too strong. Here's Vincent Collier. Benson, the 6'6 senior, nearly threw it away. Mendez Valdez off to Lee. Left it short. It'll be Western Kentucky basketball as Levi Stoops was hanging on that baseline, fighting for the basketball with Daniel Emerson.
That was kind of an interesting play. He and Emerson were both laying on the floor, but the fact that Stoops was laying out of bounds and had his hands on the ball gave the ball back to Western. Jim Burr, the very quick official down underneath on the baseline and making that walking call right there, an outstanding official. In fact, we've got a great crew here.
Fifth turnover against the Hilltoppers.
Gary Maxwell, Rick Crawford, the other two officials joining Jim Burr here tonight.
Yeah, we've got a big-time crew here in the building.
Could be said of the announcers, too. I mean. Good defense by Western Kentucky.
And Stoops forces up a tough shot, and he's fouled in the process. Darren Horn looking at his player saying, come on, be smart. You're double-teamed him on the baseline. He had nowhere to go.
You know, Dave, both of these clubs had walkovers in their first game. I mean, they really weren't contested. I mean, an easy win the other night. Western Kentucky just jumped all over Kennesaw State. And, of course, Georgia beat Southern. So tonight was really, I think, a test for both these clubs to find out what they're really made of. And the two games that have been played so far in this series, each team has won on the other's home court. And I think tonight they both expected to have a tough game, and it will be before this night's over.
Stoops gets him to go down. 11-6 Georgia. Western Kentucky beat Kennesaw State 96-55. Meanwhile, Georgia beats Southern big time 97-37. It'll be Georgia basketball.
Another turnover. Courtney Lee got up in there, and he didn't have anywhere to go with the ball. Good defensive work again by Georgia, and again Western Kentucky with a little full court pressure out there as you see Mendez Valdez out front.
Western Kentucky has gone 3.5 minutes without a point. Stoops off to Humphrey. The guy can flat out shoot it. Billy Humphrey. He hit 7 of 8 three-pointers in their opening win against Southern.
Wouldn't you love to have a guy that come off of the bench, instant offense like that?
Oh. Jam on the inside for Jeremy Evans.
Mendez Valdez with an excellent pass. Deep into the defense, kick it out to the open man. He did with an easy dunk.
Singleton kicks it out to Stoops. He'll line up a three. That's good.
Georgia shooting the ball very well from beyond the arc tonight.
Cross court pass, Lee. How does he get that open?
I want to tell you what, you got to find him. I don't care what your defense is. If you're going to help, you better know where he is on the floor.
Jackson cross court. Humphrey will shoot the three. So now he's only shooting 80% from behind the arc this year.
You know, both of these clubs go really deep into their bench. They play 8, 9, on occasion 10 players, and they don't really fall off very much after their first group goes out. Seems like to me I'm seeing more teams this year, at least early in the season, playing a lot of players, but I guess you would expect that in November and December. Good help by Singleton.
Emerson, that's a three. His second of the night.
You know, if Singleton's going to do that, he's got to get some help. If he's going to leave and double team, somebody's got to swing over and help.
Western Kentucky, Larry, 3 out of 4 from behind the arc. That's the reason they're in this, only down 3. Singleton dumps it down to the freshman Jackson. Strong move to the hole. He got the nice roll.
How about a pass from a 7-footer to a 6'10 guy? Good play inside. Oh, what a move by Emerson.
He got down the floor in a hurry. It's a 3-point Bulldog lead.
He just outran their big people, Georgia's big people. Singleton and Jackson both late getting there.
Nice touch by Sunday out of Gaines.
We may have to change the balls here that the next time out. That thing's on fire.
Larry, Western Kentucky shooting 67%. Georgia shooting 57%.
Like I said, you don't want to go away. These two clubs love the transition game, and tonight they're making a lot of shots early.
Butch Joyner checks in. Number 30 for Western Kentucky, the senior out of Nicholasville, Kentucky. A.J. Slaughter, the 6'3 freshman from Shelbyville, also on the floor for the Hilltoppers.
Coaching staff of Western Kentucky loves this freshman, Slaughter.
Bad pass by Mendez Valdez. Turnover number 7. Stoops cutting to the basket, lost the handle. It was knocked out of his hand, so it will be Georgia basketball.
Sunday out of Gaines with some excellent vision that time and delivery of the pass just a tad too late. Allowed Mendez Valdez to catch up.
Humphrey too strong off the glass. Batted around. Pulled out of there by Joyner. We've got 11:50 to go here in the opening half. Georgia has led from the opening tip. And a traveling violation against Joyner. Good defensive half-court stand by the Bulldogs. 11:37 to play in the opening half. The Georgia Bulldogs, 21, Western Kentucky, 16.
In the shadows, you challenge yourself. In the spotlight, you challenge others. You know what it takes to be number one. At State Farm, so do we.
Plane with a long history?
Not a good thing.
The
This is a lineup that cannot be stopped. A perennial powerhouse that needs no timeouts. The team, SECSports.com. And it runs up the score every week with more real-time coverage and live streaming content than ever before. Put in the play and get the results on all your favorite teams, players, and coaches. And get exclusive real-time coverage of SEC championships. Everything you need to know, everything you want to hear, everything you have to see at SECSports.com.
Tonight's Western Kentucky Georgia basketball game is brought to you by Lincoln Mercury. Back inside Stegman Coliseum, where the Bulldogs lead the Hilltoppers by five. Georgia coming off a season where they were 15-15. They went 5-11 in the SEC. They did have a couple of solid wins, but Larry, there was one of those wins against Alabama that left Georgia at that point 14-8 overall. And they were one game under 500 in the SEC. And there were thoughts that just maybe this club could get over that hump. But they faltered, lost 7 of 8. Was that just a matter of a team getting tired?
Well, I don't know if it was getting tired or whether they just didn't have the talent available. I thought they played a little over their head early. And then things begin to catch up with them. You know, as the season goes along, you start watching all those tapes. Right. People become a little bit more familiar with what you're going to do. I just didn't think that they had the talent. This year, with a little more experience now, with one of that freshman group of sophomores now, they're a much better club.
A foul underneath. That'll go against Joynter. That'll be his first. Georgia shooting 8 of 16, 2 out of 5 from behind the arc. Western Kentucky, 6 out of 9, 67%. But they've hit 3 out of 4 from behind the arc.
Rogers doing a good job on Stooks out front. Georgia trying to shake somebody free. Western Kentucky doing a good job in their man-to-man.
Levi Stooks will take a long three. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Gaines, who led the team in rebounding a year ago, grabs an offensive board and then's fouled.
How does he do that every year?
I don't know.
This is a 6'1 guard, and he's out there leading this squad in rebounding last year. I talked about the fact that he led them in assists and steals, but when you're 6'1 and leading your club at a Division I level in rebounding, you're sneaking in there and getting a lot of loose balls that are coming off of that rim. He does a great job of finding that ball.
Well, he had a career-high 10 assists for Southern. He also had 7 points and 7 rebounds in that contest. What's amazing, Larry, he was really a two-guard in high school. He's been a converted point guard, and he has adapted quite well to that job.
Well, his scoring dipped last year from the previous year, but I don't think he has to worry about this year. They just want him to deliver the basketball and give him that same floor game they expected, and they got a turnover.
The steal by Gaines, up ahead to Stooks. The alley-oop to Mercer. Oh, my, what a good-looking play from the Georgia Bulldogs. And it started on the defensive end of the floor.
That's what I'm talking about. Get that steal and convert it. Dave, last year this club was not able to do that. They would get the turnover, go to their half-court game, and wouldn't be much there. This is much more of a transition team this year. Watch him get it out. Great lob up front. Good catch, good finish by Mercer.
Larry, that was so good, we're going to call it our Dodge drive of the game.
I'm going to tell you, at the wheel right there was Stooks delivering the ball, too.
This Georgia club gave up 71 points a game a year ago. That was 11th in the Southeastern Conference. They didn't have a problem scoring over 70 points a contest. But Dennis Felton said two things have to happen. They have to be more aggressive on the defensive end, and they have to rebound the basketball. They were getting killed on the glass down the stretch last year. So far, we've seen the defensive intensity pick up, and we've also seen a little bit, a glimpse of what could be a pretty good rebounding team.
Now they're going to change defenses. Looks like a 1-3-1. They may switch it up here. Here they're going to come out of the double. Half-court trap.
They'll swing it around to Joyner. He knocks down the three.
Tell you, Western Kentucky did a good job of recognition that time. Knew where the open man was.
Dave Neal, Larry Conley from Stegman Coliseum. Glad you could join us right here on FSN. A little college basketball. Georgia and Western Kentucky. Bulldogs 1-0. Western Kentucky with the same record. This has been a high-scoring affair to this point. Both these clubs getting up and down the floor, and it continues.
There's that freshman Slaughter. They are really high on him. Not only his long-range shooting, but as he showed right there, putting on display a good mid-range game to go with it.
He's out of Shelbyville, Kentucky, Louisville's Courier Journal's Player of the Year.
Sister plays basketball at Louisville. Jackson a little bit slow getting to the rim. This freshman is going to be very, very good for Dennis Felton in the long run, but the last two possessions Georgia's had, he just hasn't gotten it and gotten it to the rim quickly enough. Well, nice ball movement right here. Look at Slaughter put the ball, one dribble to the left, up and get it in before the defense comes after you.
He didn't get greedy and take it too far into the paint. This Albert Jackson, when I asked Coach Felton about his youngster, I said, what are your plans for Albert? And he says, what are our plans for him to play right away? This is not a down-the-road project. They think his offensive skills are still a year or so away, but what he provides is a big 6'10", 250-pound frame that can rebound.
Says he wants to be a CPA or a financial consultant. He wants to try soccer and skydiving. I think maybe Dennis wants him just to stick with soccer.
So Albert will head to the bench. And I think that'll be the first of what will be many conversations we will have on camera between Coach Felton and Albert Jackson.
Here's that half-court trap again by Georgia. Boy, Mercer with those long arms out on the front.
Courtney Lee in and out. Singleton the rebound.
Well, Singleton looks so much more mature this year than he did last year. There were times last year he just got totally lost.
Newman goes with the left hand, no good.
There's another good freshman right there for Western Kentucky, Jeremy Evans.
Around the perimeter. Emerson, he knocks it down again, his third three of the game. And Western Kentucky is 5 out of 7 from behind the arc.
Great ball movement by the Hilltoppers that time, and they found one of their open and good shooters out in the corner, and that is Daniel Emerson from Norcross, Georgia.
Nice runner from Sundiata Gaines. Gaines now with 6. Out of the hands of Jeremy Evans.
Evans having the same problem Jackson has, not getting the ball up to the rim quickly enough or getting it out to an open man.
Singleton posting up on Emerson. Here comes a double team, and Singleton took a little hop step. And that'll be a turnover. That'll be the Bulldogs' fourth of the game. You know what Western Kentucky's doing here by the three-point shooting? They're buying time with Tyrone Brazelton, their starting point guard, on the bench with 2 fouls. He left, and we'd only played 3.5 minutes of this game.
And obviously Darren Horn has decided he's not going to put him back in there, because when that lead got to 9, I thought maybe he might entertain thoughts of putting him back in this game, but not so.
Those 10 turnovers have been the real deciding factor, make it 11 turnovers now. But the good news for Western Kentucky, they're down 4, 7:53 to go here in the opening half.
Here's a crystal story you won't believe.
We're on our way to school, he gets hungry.
Oh, a crystal with mustard and ketchup.
The thing was, his fuel light was on.
So we pull into this oasis of crystals and gasoline. We're like, let's get the crystals before we get the gas. And my truck just goes, bruh, 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 bruh.
And we're forced to push it to the window.
We worked up an appetite doing that. We got our food, put the gas on the car.
It's all good.
I got him to clap.
And that's our crystal story.
At your Dodge dealer, it's all about the best in American and German engineering and design. And now during the 2006 model year-end clearance, get 0% financing for 60 months on all 2006 Dodge trucks. Get Durango with the best interior room in its class. Or grab 0 for 60 on Dakota. Or Ram 1500 at heavy duty, both best in durability. So hurry into your Dodge dealer today. During the Dodge model year-end clearance, get 0% financing for 60 months on all 2006 Dodge trucks. Hurry, this offer ends soon.
College basketball hits the court with a full week of SEC action on FSN South.
Oh, is that ever pretty?
Tomorrow at 7, Miami of Ohio takes on Randolph Morris and the Wildcats. Then later at 9, it's Georgetown at Vanderbilt. Then Friday at 7, more Kentucky action as the Wildcats host Mississippi Valley State.
Oh, what a play!
A full week of SEC basketball action continues tomorrow at 7 on FSN South.
The Dogs and the Hilltoppers from Athens. It has been a three-point shooting festival for Western Kentucky. 5 out of 7 from behind the arc. Georgia shooting 50%, 10 out of 20, 2 out of 6 from behind the arc. Well, we got a second, Larry. I think it's appropriate to mention Georgia fans will be interested in, to know this. And Channing Toney, their junior guard out of Snellville, Georgia, who has not participated, been with the team the last few weeks for some personal reasons, has decided that he will leave the Georgia program and transfer. Out of the corner, Billy Humphrey knocks down his second three of the game.
Is that a sweet shot or what?
It is pure.
I mean, it is definitely pure.
Emerson back to Brazelton, who just checked in.
Kind of figured he might be back here. With strict instructions about not to foul. You know that was the last sentence uttered over there by Dern.
Shot clock at 5, lead to the basket, silky smooth.
How about the menu of shots he's got? I mean, he's come off a screen, he's created his own shot, and that time he took it to the rim.
Gaines tried to draw the third on Brazelton, but he backed off. Gaines missed the shot, and here come the Hilltoppers. Courtney Lee to the basket, blocking foul underneath.
You know, Dave, when clubs get in trouble, they usually go to their main man. Let's go back and look at this Georgia move again. Look at that wonderful shot up by Humphrey in the corner. And, of course, Western Kentucky's got their own version of being able to make shots, and Courtney Lee is the guy that does it for them. You know, you looked at the guy that's going to carry you offensively, and Lee is the man that they will look to this season. I mean, he just gives them such a plethora of shots. I mean, it's everywhere.
Well, one of the great aspects of him is he gets to the free throw line quite a bit. Despite being a perimeter player, we see why he likes to get to the basket as well. He went to the free throw line 118 times a year ago and knocked down 110, an 84% clip. That's a good way to get to 17 points a game.
It would not surprise me if he was in the 20 to 22 range this year the way he's playing. As I said, this is a very deep squad, this Western Kentucky team, as is Georgia. How many players have we counted so far? Western have played, what'd you say, 11?
10.
10.
They got 10. Georgia's played 10 as well. If you got a jersey on, good chance you're going to get in. Mercer misses the jump shot. Mercer, 2 out of 5. Make that 2 out of 6 from the floor tonight. Brazelton inside, tough shot. Mercer answers with a block. Humphrey quit on the run, and it's a turnover, and it gives it back to Western Kentucky. And Brazelton looks like he might have banged that shoulder pretty hard.
Pretty tough for a guy his size at 5'11 to go in and challenge the trees right here. An easy block by Mike Mercer. He just sent, oh, there's what happened right there. Bliss fell on top of him. I'd be hurting, too, if Bliss fell on top of me.
6'10", 255, falling on top of Brazelton, who weighs maybe 170 pounds. Brazelton stays in, and a jump ball with Steve Newman. Possession arrow favors Western Kentucky. They'll have 24 on the shot.
Dave, right now, Brazelton is over-penetrating. He's got guys open on the wings, and he's getting down inside. It's almost as if Georgia's inviting him to come inside because they know they're going to get him in trouble. He has nowhere to go with the ball because of his size. Needs to be a little bit quicker getting it out, and he turns it over.
12th turnover by Western Kentucky with 6:09 to go here in the opening half. They're shooting the ball well when they can get a shot off. 10 out of 16 and 5 out of 8 from behind the three-point line.
Those TOs will kill you, though.
You never want more turnovers than field goals made, and that's where they're at right now. 12 turnovers, 10 field goals.
Western Kentucky back in his own defense. They're matching up out of this.
Roska rips it out of there. Aaron pass. Here's Rogers. He'll line up a three. That's off the mark. Batted around. Emerson with it. He's triple teamed underneath. Got the shot off, and he will step to the free throw line.
You know, I was watching him in practice yesterday, and one of the drills that Western Kentucky has is getting a bunch of people around a guy who's got the ball and watching them power up underneath. Emerson did that better than anybody on this Western Kentucky squad. And guess what? It just came to life right there. Three people on top of him. A good ball fake got him in the air, and he got the foul.
Norcross High School just down the road from here in Athens, Georgia. Emerson averaged just shy of 4 points last year, three rebounds. Jackson back on the floor. Newman and Bliss take a seat.
Davey's really good at facing the basket and shooting, as he's exhibited here tonight. But one of the things he worked on the offseason was putting the ball on the floor. He's gotten much better at that.
Leads the club with a dozen points tonight. Leads everybody in the game with a dozen. Here's Humphrey. Back to Stoops, back to Humphrey. Long three, no good.
He almost got it. Just a hair off. I think his range is unlimited.
Emerson lost the handle. Another turnover by Western Kentucky.
Well, again, Emerson, watch him get the ball, just catch and shoot. Now, this is a 6'8 guy who usually plays the post for Western Kentucky. How much better does that make them when they've got an offensive player that can step away from the basket and shoot like that?
Three three-pointers for Emerson tonight. And then he came with a takeaway.
Singleton a little lazy receiving that pass. You've got to go out there and get it.
Emerson, the first one back down the floor for Western Kentucky. Mendez Valdez guarded by Gaines. Here's Rogers, who had to play the point last year. A natural two guard. Shot clock down to seven. Lee had it ripped out of his hands by Gaines. Back to Mendez Valdez. That's off the foot of a Bulldog player, but inadvertent, and it comes into the hands of Levi Stoops. Singleton underneath, little hook off the glass is good.
See, I tell you what, he has gotten so much better. Singleton went to Pete Newell's big man camp this past summer. I'll tell you more about that story when we come back.
Timeout on the floor. Singleton, the seven-footer. They said it was a project a year ago. Well, the project's looking pretty good right now.
Gives me the feeling like she's not, like, listening to me.
Have you tried not saying like every other word?
What?
Remember your ski trip story?
Yeah.
I was, like, going down the hill, and, like, there was a crowd,
no,
and, like,
come on, that's
and
not
I was, like,
me.
Stuff either happens or it doesn't.
Holy.
If you want to make your hard-earned dollar go a whole lot farther, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has the low prices guaranteed to save you money. Get ready to get the best price possible on all the parts and accessories you need with our ready-to-go low price guarantee. Nobody can beat our prices on just about anything for your car. So when you want to get more for your money while getting more out of your car, get to Advance Auto Parts for our everyday ready-to-go low price guarantee. Ready in advance.
The Ford F-150 Super Crew or the Toyota Tundra Double Cab. The Tundra Double Cab has a bed over a half foot longer than the F-150 Super Crew. Now you may think that doesn't matter to you, but we found the tailgate is much more effective when closed. the full-size Toyota Tundra, a truck that handles the whole job.
Now get $4,000 cash back plus the Sport Package discount for a total savings of $6,000 on the Tundra Double Cab. Toyota, moving forward.
You're watching FSN South.
Tonight's Western Kentucky-Georgia basketball game is brought to you by Advance Auto Parts and by Ford.
Larry, we were talking about Rashad Singleton, a 7-foot, 255-pound sophomore out of Campbellton, Florida. And you've noticed, and we both noticed, even in practice, how much his game has improved. And it, I mean, just a little bit can be a dramatic difference for a guy who's 7 foot.
Yeah, I think from a physical standpoint, you've got to understand he's put on about 25 to 30 pounds. He looks more mature. He went to that camp this past summer out in California, and what it did was give him a lot of confidence. He now feels like he can really compete down inside. He even admitted last year there were times he just got simply lost out there on the floor.
They'll dump it down to Singleton, quickly double team.
See, there, look at that pass out. That last year, he couldn't do that.
Good recognition. Georgia couldn't knock the shot down. Western Kentucky with 15 turnovers, including five in their last six trips down the floor. But, hey, they're only down four. And had a chance to be down one, but that shot wouldn't go by Lee. Here comes Billy Humphrey off to Gaines. Evans knocks it out of bounds. It'll be Georgia basketball. Our Chevy halftime report coming your way in 3 minutes and 20 seconds. We'll have a little look at Levi Stukes, one of two seniors on this Georgia team. We'll also focus in on some of these SEC big men that could play a prominent role in the 06-07 campaign.
You and I have been around the SEC for a number of years. I've never seen a year when we've had so many good big people in this league.
There's a pretty good one right there playing for Western Kentucky. Jeremy Evans, the freshman out of Crossett, Arkansas.
Watch Evans again. This is another one of those freshmen the Western Kentucky staff is really high on. He comes from a state in which the basketball has been pretty good, state of Arkansas. Every year I look at rosters, I see one or two kids just sprinkled around the Southeastern Conference from Arkansas on almost every roster.
It seems like Arkansas or Memphis. Mike Mercer's from right here in Atlanta. He gets it to go down. That foul on Mercer. That'll be his first.
That's the first move we've seen from Benson Caller that time. Let's go back and take a look at the good shot. Good move down inside. I'll tell you what, when you can take one step and go 12 feet, you're doing pretty well.
I don't know what that's like. Even on a trampoline, I'd have trouble accomplishing that. Collier knocks down the free throw. Woodbury back on the floor.
This redshirt senior is a transfer from Florida State. Tell you one thing, he is a strong offensive rebounder, just simply plays within himself.
Started 19 of 31 games a year ago. Averaged four rebounds, about 9 points a game. Spent his first 2 years in Tallahassee.
I think my partner was there for a little while.
I spent a few hours there, yeah.
I thought so.
As you say years, to me it felt like hours.
A little offense.
Felt like decades, I'm sure. Yeah. Offensive foul underneath. Speaking of that, Jeff Bowden, the offensive coordinator of Florida State, resigned today.
Oh.
It's not a good thing when you get shut out 30-0 at home.
Yeah. Well, that's a place where they take their football pretty seriously. It has not been a good year for the Seminoles.
Gaines on the floor. Mercer to the bench. 2:35 to go in the opening half. Things have slowed down. We had a back-and-forth first 10 minutes of this game.
I think Humphrey's going to pick up another foul.
That'll be his second. So Collier back to the free throw line out of St. Petersburg, Florida.
Levi Stukes and Mike Mercer.
You know, Dave, one of the things that's happened this year is Dennis Felton's relaxed his rules a little bit and let the guys have some facial hair. So you can see right there, Dave Bliss has got a little beard growing. But then he may be the only guy that's even old enough to be able to put some hair on his face, as young as this club is.
It's funny, Levi Stukes has a little bit going as well, the two seniors. Western Kentucky hanging around, only down two. They've hit 8 out of 10 at the free throw line, 5 out of 10 from behind the arc. That's despite 15 turnovers. Stukes extends that lead back to 5.
Well, I just can't tell you how important it is to have a senior guard that can do the things that he does. Shoot, rebound, defend, pass. And he does it all.
Woodbury with great hustle on the defensive side. It's off to Mercer. Three-second violation against Albert Jackson. He was trying to get that ball.
Well, I talked about the ability to rebound, assist, defend. Levi Stukes can shoot it, too. Came off of that screen. Made a big one. I'll tell you, Stukes can do just everything.
How about him coming off the bench now, the first two games? He has given way to the combination of Mike Mercer and Terrence Woodbury, who are playing that 2 and 3 role for Georgia. Batted out of there by Bliss. 15 on the shot clock.
Oh, that's a carry.
Emerson had it blocked by Jackson.
Did he get that one?
Mercer in the lane. Got it.
I'll tell you one thing. Evans was pretty close to knocking it back out, too. Nice move by Mercer.
Courtney Lee, bounce pass in the corner. A.J. Slaughter, no good. Tapped around, it'll be Georgia basketball.
Entertainment from end to end. Slaughter tried to go inside, tried to get it on the pass. Good block. Look at this block by Jackson. Knocked it back, Mercer got it, went to the other end, and up and over the top as Jeremy Evans tried to knock it back, too.
Offensive foul against Albert Jackson. Stuck that hip out trying to set a screen. That'll be his second.
It'll be interesting to watch the progress of this freshman. You know, he played at Oak Hill Academy last year, and they only went 40-1.
Finished second in the country in the final rankings. But as you and I were saying, if he was this, he was the backup center, he didn't even start.
Yeah, but there's a long-standing relationship between he and Dennis Felton. He's known him since the eighth grade. Good shot by Lee.
Big-time shot by Lee. He's got a dozen. Shot clock is turned off. Georgia can hold for the final shot. Their lead is 4. Mendez Valdez guarding Mercer. And Dennis Felton wants a timeout. He's got 9.5 seconds to work with. Dennis Felton. There's a new inductee into the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame. Andy Landers, head coach of the Georgia Lady Bulldogs. They got off to a good start, won their opener. Came to his practice today. Boy, he is a real basketball tactician. It's fun to watch him coach a practice. A lot of people see his antics and his loud vocal direction, if you will. But when it comes to knowing the game, there are a few people that know it as well as he does.
It's a rather tame way to put it.
Yeah. He's also got a great sense of humor.
Yeah, he does. Great, and congratulations to him, too. I mean, that's a wonderful honor. Well-deserved. Spent many years here at the University of Georgia. He's had a lot of very successful teams. And like all good coaches, compliments his players for putting him in the position to be able to get
Absolutely.
Into the Hall of Fame.
First thing out of his mouth was the only reason he's going is because he's had some good players. Down to 2. Humphrey with 1. Got it! At the end of the half, Billy Humphrey. A big-time shot from a big-time player.
Well, it was a barrage of bombs in the first half, and this is the man that led them all, Billy Humphrey. We talked about it earlier. Dave, he's got a sweet stroke.
Humphrey, 3 out of 5 from behind the arc. He's got 9 points, and the Dogs lead it by 7. Back with our halftime activities right after this.
Cow!
Good, Aaron, cow.
Cow!
Yes, sweetie, cow. Paul, where are the burgers?
Try Chick-fil-A's new hand-spun milkshakes in vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, and cookies and cream.
4,800 student athletes. 2,200 named to academic honor roll. 17 named first team academic All-American. 12 universities. One mission. The Southeastern.
I rise as night falls and the arena fills through a sea of red, ready to witness my power to power through. I defy to be denied. No reset, baby. This is game time. Find your way. Feel my flow. Know your role as we roll out from the darkness and into the spotlight of the night. Watch their eyes and realize as I rise.
WKU basketball tips off November 19th. Get your season ticket package today.
Attention all AOL customers. AOL is now free when you add Insight Broadband. Why stick with slow dial-up or DSL when you can keep your AOL email address, access AOL features and content, including free virus protection, and do it up to 70 times faster than dial-up with Insight Broadband. The best part? You can add Insight Broadband for just $30 a month. Free AOL, $30 Insight Broadband, the perfect combo. Call 866-99-INSIGHT now.
CS Breakdown, Friday on FSN.
You're watching FSN South.
And welcome to our presentation of the Chevrolet Halftime Report. Georgia leading Western Kentucky by 7. Well, guard Levi Stukes has seen the highs and lows at Georgia in his 4 seasons here in Athens. Let's get a closer look at the senior from Randallstown, Maryland.
Levi Jamal Stukes. I'm 6'1", 200 pounds. Shooting guard in the University of Georgia. I came to Georgia because in high school I didn't know about the SAT scores and I took my scores late. And Coach Felton, as well as all the other coaching staff, came and saw me play in a local league, and I did real well at that time. And they just been sticking by me throughout my whole high school career. My last year, the love that they showed me made me feel like this was the place for me. I felt it even more from the love from the fans and the community. The scouting report on me is a great shooter from the perimeter, good on the bar defender, a lot of energy, and just do whatever he got to do in order to win. The secret of being a great shooter is just always being prepared to shoot, just have your whole body set and ready to shoot the ball. It's my last year, you know, it's another year for me to play this game that I love the most. Perimeter game this year would be, I think, a lot more open. You know, we got a lot more guys coming back. All of us came back with a whole new mentality, and, you know, we just ready to get this thing started. I don't know how front court will be this year because, you know, coming into practice, we don't know who's going to be out there to play to start the game, but we know that we all going to give it our best and may the best man win. Can I say that again? I'm sorry. What's the question again? Well, my favorite thing about Georgia is the fans. You know, coming into the school year, I knew the fans was going to be behind us a little bit more because we won a little bit more games last year, and they just ready to support us. So The fans is a big reason. My favorite thing about Coach Felton is when I shoot the ball from three and it might be a close game and he kick his foot back and lean back. As to say, he's shooting the three and watching it go in, and then finally when it go in, he give himself a clap as well as myself, and you know, he just wait for the next one to get shot up again. We lost a tree buddy, a tree teammate, some of our best friend. We lost our friend Kevin Brophy to a car accident. He's in a better place right now, and I know he's looking on our team and giving us all the strength that we need in order to go out and win. We just ready to get this started and show him that we haven't forgot about him, and we dedicated the whole year to him. Senior year, last chance. No hold back. See you soon.
Oh, there's tradition here. More than you ever imagined. The teams in this league, they've been locking headgear since Ed's work year. Can you smell it? Hear that? It's tradition. Winning tradition. The SEC sent more teams to bowl games than any other conference in the nation. And they were the first to match up two divisional winners in a conference championship game. Now where are you going to find that? Where else but football in the SEC? Tradition to you, tradition to me.
This holiday season, leave the perfect hint for your wish list. Dreams come true during the Lincoln Mercury Wish List event. Featuring the redesigned 2007 Lincoln Navigator. The SUV that started it all is once again making its presence known. Bring home the original, starting at this great price. Find the ultimate holiday gift during the Lincoln Mercury Wish List event.
Cordless power tools and rechargeable batteries help you do projects all over the house. Inside, outside, they let you work anywhere. But did you know that by recycling old rechargeable batteries, you can help protect the environment? It's true. When they no longer hold a charge and need to be replaced, old rechargeable batteries should be recycled. It's easy and it's free.
Recycle your old rechargeable batteries wherever you buy cordless power tools. Go to calltorecycle.org to find a collection site near you.
Not surprisingly, the auto company known for its responsive handling and exceptional reliability also has the best gas mileage. Honda, the most fuel-efficient auto company in America.
Lease a Honda Accord for $249 a month for well-qualified customers.
You're watching FSN South.
There's many reasons why the SEC is the best basketball conference in the country, and one of the reasons is we have the best collection of big men as a conference in the country.
Look at our Chevy halftime report scoreboard, where the Georgia Bulldogs lead Western Kentucky 43-36. Dave Neal back alongside Larry Conley, and staying on that theme, Larry, of big men in this league. For a number of years back in the late 90s, even the early part of the 2000s, this was a guard-dominated league. That has quickly changed. Some big men are starting to make a name for themselves, and this could be, seriously, the best year of big men the SEC has had in maybe 30, 40 years.
Yeah, I agree, and of course the leading guy in that group is Joakim Noah. I just think he's an outstanding center. But Dave, it doesn't end there, trust me. There are a number of quality big men, and when you look through this league, you're going to find out very quickly you're going to go up against some very, very tough inside people.
You look at Dwayne Curtis of Ole Miss. He had a bad foot early on. He seems to be getting closer to good health. Jamario Davidson. How about Big Baby Davis? Al Horford along with Joakim Noah. Randolph Morris of Kentucky. He seems to be back with the Vincents. One of my favorite players is Charles Rhodes over at Mississippi State. And Towns at Arkansas. I mean, they've got a couple of guys at Arkansas that could be considered premier big men.
Well, and again, as we take a look at some of these players, you're going to understand that the way they play is the way you want them to play. This is a big man, Darian Towns, at 6'10", a club that's gotten a lot of scoring from the perimeter. They're going to need more from him down on the inside. But he's one of just many. And we've talked about Glenn Davis. I mean, he is just, he's the reigning player of the year. What else can you say? He's actually trimmed down. He's gotten bigger. He's gotten stronger. And there's not as much fat around there, but he's still big.
Yeah, he can still play the game of basketball, too. And to put a final period on this, we've got a big man right here that both you and I are very impressed with, Rashad Singleton of Georgia, a sophomore. In the first half, he has shown his ability to get up and down the floor much better than he did a year ago.
Well, he has. And I said this in the statement. I'll stick by it. I think he's the most improved big man this conference may have to offer this year. He may not be the best, but he's certainly the most improved.
And they've got another so-called project here in Albert Jackson, who also looks like he could be a good one before it's all said and done. Georgia leads Western Kentucky by 7. Back with more right after this.
No matter how it starts, no matter how it ends, I won't let you down, I won't let you down. No matter where you've been,
introducing the world's smallest camera flip phone, the Pantech C300. Fully loaded, shrunk to fit. Only from Singular. Raising the bar.
I am the first and only lady truck driver for my company. There's nothing else I'd rather be doing. When I have a headache, it feels like a traffic jam in my head.
Oops, sorry.
I can't stop what I'm doing when my head's pounding and my back's killing me. That's why BC is always by my side. BC works so fast because it's a powder. Look, a convoy. It's just like putting pedal to the metal. It's fast. I'm Carolyn from Ashboro, and I never hit the road without BC.
Friday, December 1st, 12 o'clock, the Hyatt Regency Atlanta. Two men, two opposing leaders will sit down for one final civilized discussion. Join Dave Neal as he hosts the two men whose teams will battle it out for this year's SEC football crown. It's the Hyatt Regency SEC Championship Coaches Luncheon. For tickets, call 205-458-3000 or order online.
Vehix.com helps people find the car they want at a dealer near them. How do we improve that user experience?
Free squeegee service.
And your idea?
VHIX TV, with helpful video buying guides that make online shopping more fun.
Helpful video buying guides, now at VHIX.com. Roadmap to the automotive world.
I rise as night falls and the arena fills through a sea of red, ready to witness my power to power through. I defy to be denied. No reset, baby. This is game time. Find your way. Feel my flow. Know your role as we roll out from the darkness and into the spotlight of the night. Watch their eyes and realize as I rise.
WKU basketball tips off November 19th. Get your season ticket package today.
Hear it, believe it. This week at 9 Eastern.
The Kentucky Wildcats host Miami of Ohio Wednesday at 7 on FSN South.
We're back inside Stegman Coliseum as we continue with our Chevrolet halftime report. Georgia leads at 43-36. And from the opening tip-off, Georgia got off to a really good start. They've led the whole way. They've had one tie early in this game, but Georgia's been out in front most of the way, and they've done it on both ends of the floor.
Let's take a look at some of the halftime highlights. And when we talk about Georgia, it's got to be Mike Mercer as one of those guys we'll talk about. Great catch and finish right here down underneath. Watch again as he makes the nice spin move, the turning just over the edge of the rim on his move into the lane. And, of course, how about Billy Humphrey with that sweet shot from about 20 feet down the right side. For Western Kentucky, it was a little bit different story. There it is, Emerson again. Daniel Emerson nailing one of his three-point field goals. He had three of them. And then Courtney Lee on the outside had a terrific first half.
Well, Lee with a dozen, Emerson with a dozen. Western Kentucky still in this. One more half of basketball coming your way. This has been our Chevrolet Halftime Report.
Get a Volkswagen and receive a custom first act guitar. Plug into the stereo and make your V-Dub rock.
This Aptify has airbags.
I'm all right.
Right now, get a 2007 Jetta starting at just $16,490.
Here's a crystal story you won't believe.
We're on our way to school. He gets hungry.
Oh, a crystal with mustard and ketchup. Mmm.
The thing was, his fuel light was on.
So we pull into this oasis of crystals and gasoline. We're like, oh, let's get the crystals before we get the gas. And my truck just goes, bruh, 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 bruh.
And we're forced to push it to the window.
We worked up an appetite doing that. We got our food. Put the gas on the car.
It's all good.
I got him to clap.
And that's our crystal story.
This is a lineup that cannot be stopped. A perennial powerhouse that needs no timeouts. The team, SECSports.com. And it runs up the score every week with more real-time coverage and live streaming content than ever before. Put in the play and get the results on all your favorite teams, players, and coaches. And get exclusive real-time coverage of SEC championships. Everything you need to know, everything you want to hear, everything you have to see. At SECSports.com.
Coming up on the next Around the South, the first place Hawks look to buck Milwaukee. We have got all the post-game coverage, plus getting a grip on the NBA's new basketballs. It's not as easy as you think. An Auburn linebacker who's not only a student athlete, but a teacher as well. And up close with the Thrashers' Ilya Kovalchuk, the man is fire on ice. On Around the South tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern Time.
Georgia leading Western Kentucky by 7. Moments away from second half hoops from Stegman Coliseum. Georgia will inbound the basketball in the first half. Western Kentucky played 11 players. Georgia played 9. 8 of them scored. Pretty good production if you can go that deep.
Well, I think it's going to be something that both of these coaches are going to use a lot of players this year, and why not? You got that much talent. Good move by Singleton inside.
It's almost like he was waiting for the double team that never came. Got his own miss, back to Gaines. Emerson having a heck of a game so far. And then he's fouled by Mike Mercer on a reach-in. That'll be his second. Take a look at our first half stats, Larry, and what sticks out besides the turnovers.
Well, I mean, when you look at the number of turnovers they've had, Western Kentucky was 16 in the first half, and Georgia turned it over 10 times. I'm telling Dave, while we were away last year in this game, Georgia had 30 turnovers, Western Kentucky had 28. So they've kind of picked up where they left off.
Is that more good defense than anything?
I think a lot of it has to do with defense, yes.
Newman the rebound. Off to Gaines. That's knocked out of Gaines' hands by Courtney Lee. Courtney Lee, 4 out of 7 from the floor, couple of three-pointers, 12 points. Did not have a single rebound or an assist.
They just want him to score and defend. That's what they're interested in, his presence on the floor.
Meanwhile, Emerson had 12 points, 5 rebounds. Here's Newman inside. Finger roll. No good. Singleton had his hands on it and couldn't corral it. Rebound pulled out of there by Mike Walker. Brazelton knocks down the 15-footer. Brazelton with his first field goal today.
Well, those fouls kept him on the bench over there. I mean, he just didn't have much playing time.
5 minutes. Florida. The number one ranked team in the country taking on North Florida. They lead it by 25. Woodbury from the corner, left it short. Singleton the rebound. He's got to be a little more aggressive with the basketball.
Well, and he's going to be a little quicker with it, too. I mean, one of the things they tried to teach him this summer in that big man camp, when you get the basketball, do something with it. Take it to the basket, get it up there. If you're 7 feet tall, you should be going to the rim. If not, get it out of there and get it to an open man. And right now, Singleton out of the game. Probably to have a conversation over there with Pete Herman, the assistant coach, and also Dennis Felton, who is standing and looking at him right in his chest.
Yeah. That foul on Collier. That's Collier's first. Offensive foul. Albert Jackson trying to post up. That's his third. And Singleton back on the floor in a hurry for Jackson.
Well, this Western Kentucky team just looks different when Brazelton's on the floor.
Oh.
for Woodbury. He's doing a nice job on lead. Here's Brazelton. Gaines doing a nice job on Brazelton. Got by.
Emerson working hard underneath, threw the foul after he got the offensive rebound.
Dave, I wanted to point out a couple of guys here. There's Pete Herman. He's in his fourth season at Georgia with Dennis Felton. Was the head coach at the Naval Academy for 6 years. In fact, was there when David Robinson was there. And then on the other side for Western Kentucky, Paul Sandifer is in his third season as a full-time assistant. For 15 seasons, he was the head coach of the women's program and won 75% of his games. So important to have experienced assistants, and both of these guys are quality people.
Kind of a weird situation for Paul Sandiford. He left to take the head job at Nebraska, and then some coaching changes on the men's side. Darren Horn took over the program, and he was one assistant coach shy, and Paul Sandiford came back to Bowling Green and kind of volunteered his time, and the next thing you know, he's been on the bench the last 4 years.
I'm sure Darren and Dennis will both tell you how important both of those guys are to what they do.
Lee's following.
Good rebound by Singleton.
Big fella, aggressive on the board. Bad pass, turnover by the Dogs. Here's Brazelton. Inside his finger roll. That's what the point guard can do. Brazelton with a couple of baskets here in the second half.
Hilltoppers are just a different basketball team when he's on the floor. They're a step quicker. They look for him. He looks for them.
Georgia 0 for 4 from the floor. Three turnovers this half. They will go to the free throw line, however, as Mercer draws the foul.
Tyrone Brazelton, young man, a junior college player. Once you make this move around Singleton right there, avoided the player control foul and got it up on the rim. I'm going to tell you what, if I'm 7 feet tall, I'm not going to take a charge. I'm going to knock the ball back. And that's the one thing that I think Singleton, Rashad Singleton, has got to learn to do. Don't stand there and take that charge. You're 7 feet. Be more aggressive.
Mercer knocks down the free throw.
Billy Humphrey in for Georgia.
Humphrey on the floor, the sharpshooter. He knocked down 3 3-pointers in the first half. Five-point game. Georgia out in front, 16-20 to go. Dave Neal, Larry Conley, glad you could be with us.
You know, that's part of his game that he really needs to compensate for, and that's his overcompensation for really driving too much into the defense. Over-penetration.
Newman battling for the loose ball. Vincent Collier comes out of there with it. Emerson trying to set a screen on Mercer. Does so. Brazelton fires off the iron. Mercer the rebound. Up ahead to Humphrey. Wide open, but will take it inside. Got tied up. Offensive foul. Probably should have shot it. When you got a shot as good as Billy Humphrey, you shouldn't pass up the wide open three. The Dogs by five. Timeout on the floor.
With you and the road. The all-new turbocharged Acura RDX with super handling all-wheel drive. Acura. Advance.
Cordless power tools and rechargeable batteries help you do projects all over the house. Inside, outside, they let you work anywhere. But did you know that by recycling old rechargeable batteries, you can help protect the environment? It's true. When they no longer hold a charge and need to be replaced, old rechargeable batteries should be recycled. It's easy and it's free.
Recycle your old rechargeable batteries wherever you buy cordless power tools. Go to calltorecycle.org to find a collection site near you.
I got to get up early. I got to be on time. I got to go busting, man. I got to go get mine. I am that kind of guy.
Ford Tough.
You're watching FSN South.
Georgia leading it by 5, 15, 36 to go in the basketball game. Our trivia question: which city was Dominique Wilkins born? Now think about that for a moment. And this summer was a special one for Dominique as he made his way up to the Naismith Basketball Memorial Hall of Fame, where he was inducted after a great career here at Georgia, where he was a two-time All-American. Then he went on to play 14 years in the NBA and scored over 25,000 points. He and Charles Barkley were inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame. Congrats to those guys.
Quick sidebar to that. Some years ago, I used to run a basketball camp with invitations to only the best players. And we had Dominique Wilkins and Ralph Sampson both show up. And the first time I ever saw Dominique Wilkins play, he went right down the middle against the 7'4 Ralph Sampson and dunked over him. I said, this guy can play. He can definitely play.
Yeah.
He was a junior in high school at that time. Oh, what a great player. There were 200 college coaches in attendance, and every one of them stood up.
Georgia 0 for 5, Larry, out of the locker room. Try to break that string right here. Here's Newman.
Both these clubs really shot well in the first half.
Mercer, tough shot, no good. Tapped around, who's got it? Collier of Western Kentucky.
Talking about passing up a shot earlier as Humphrey did. I thought Newman had a wide open shot from 8 feet he should have taken there.
Maresca misses the shot. Easy offensive rebound, but Singleton finally takes it out of there. And then threw it away. Mike Mercer says, my fault, big fella. And now it's getting a little sloppy. We have played 5 minutes and 18 seconds, and Georgia has yet to hit a field goal.
Hilltoppers have turned it over 19 times so far. That's incredible.
Woodbury now on the floor for the Bulldogs.
One four set coming off of that post on the right side. Got to keep an eye on Lee, as Woodbury is.
Lee, pull up jumper, got it. Oh, that's big time right there.
You know, he just creates a little bit of space. All he needs is about a step and a half. And if he gets it, it's going to go up. Anywhere from 15 to 22 feet, he's going to launch.
He's just a junior, but already NBA scouts are taking notice of the young man. They were, when Western Kentucky played Kennesaw State, they were reports that were there five NBA scouts, where we have double figures from the National Basketball Association here tonight. Shot clock down to 7. Humphrey.
It's got to go up.
Bliss with 2 on the shot clock. In and out. Rebound Collier.
Western Kentucky is about to battle back. They could take the lead or get a tie right here with a 3.
Good dribble drive by Brazelton, who pulls up, knocks down the jumper. Hilltoppers down 1. Mercer sees a seam. He gets it to go down.
You know what Brazelton did to him? He just did to Brazelton. Both of them with deep penetration to the rim.
And the second time tonight, Brazelton called for palming.
I saw a game the other night where I had 5 palming calls that I witnessed. And I thought, yeah, maybe the officials are going to really crack down on this year.
Well, as I discussed earlier, it was a point of emphasis. But we've heard that over and over again, and not much has really happened. But apparently, from what we're seeing in the early games here of this college basketball season, they have underlined emphasis on palming the basketball. And I don't think that's a bad thing.
No, I would agree.
Bliss nearly got it to go down. He'll step to the free throw line.
Number 22, Vincent Collier. His second, the team's third.
You know, back to that palming thing real quick, Larry, and that is, you know, these officials were saying they could almost call it every time down the floor. And he says it, and these guys are, you know, in their defense, it's not their job to teach the players not to palm. It's got to happen back in elementary, middle school as they develop along the way. Revisit quickly our Toyota trivia question of the night. What city was Dominic Wilkins born? If you said Paris, France, you are our lucky winner, and you get nothing.
How about a trip to Paris, Kentucky? Is that right?
Yeah, why not? Every time I see guys dribble the basketball and I see him carry the ball, I think back to Bob Cousy and how he used to dribble and how successful he was in the old school ways.
Exactly.
Collier had it blocked by Humphrey. Woodbury up ahead to Humphrey. On Collier, count the basket.
Collier allowed his shot to be blocked on the other end, and he compounded the problem by committing the foul on the other end. Sometimes that's what we call a foul of frustration. Watch again. Well, that's a terrific block right there. Humphrey going, getting it, and then finishing it up on the other end as he draws the foul and makes the basket.
Humphrey got off to such a great start early in the year last season. He had some big-time games. He was the only Bulldog with a double-double last year when he had 15 and 10 against Eastern Kentucky. Scored in double figures in 7 of the first 8 games, but only 5 of the last 18. Once again, that tape got out.
Yep.
Yeah. It circulated around the SEC. Foul against Levi Stoops. That'll be his first. Or Dave Bliss, excuse me. Georgia basketball. Georgia had a 1-point lead just 2 minutes ago. They have stretched it out to 8.
Got to take better care of the basketball.
Georgia's biggest lead tonight was back in the first half when it was 9.
Good tip in by Bliss. Get that big paw up there right on the rim.
Georgia with a double-figure lead tonight at 10. Evans sets a screen. Mendez Valdez. Oh, nice shot.
He did a nice job of protecting the ball with his body that time. Laid it up with that outside hand, and no one for Georgia could get to it to block it. Pretty play.
Stoops dumps it off to Bliss. He'll back his way in. Strong move, has nothing to show for it. Rebound Evans. Mendez, Valdez, no good. It's a follow by Evans. The left hand goes down.
How about that? He just reached back and threw it down the well.
Wow. That is just a freshman. Back to a 6-point game. Here's Humphrey, gets a screen from Woodbury. High arching shot off the back of the iron. And a foul on Woodbury trying to grab the rebound. Timeout on the floor. 10:34 to go in the game. Couple of quick baskets by Western Kentucky. They've closed it back to 6. Stay with us.
The Ford F-150 or the Toyota Tundra. Who's got the most standard horsepower? Well, with a big iForce V8, the Tundra has 40 more horses than the F-150. With that much more standard horsepower, you'll always be in the passing lane. The full-size Toyota Tundra. Go ahead. Take our horses for a ride.
Now get $4,000 cash back or 0% APR financing for 60 months on all 2006 Tundra models. Toyota, moving forward.
If you want to make your hard-earned dollar go a whole lot farther, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has the low prices guaranteed to save you money. Get ready to get the best price possible on all the parts and accessories you need with our ready-to-go low price guarantee. Nobody can beat our prices on just about anything for your car. So when you want to get more for your money while getting more out of your car, get to Advance Auto Parts for our everyday ready-to-go low price guarantee. Ready in advance.
At your Dodge dealer, it's all about the best in American and German engineering and design. And now during the 2006 model year-end clearance, get 0% financing for 60 months on all 2006 Dodge trucks. Get Durango with the best interior room in its class. Or grab 0 for 60 on Dakota. Or Ram 1500 at heavy duty, both best in durability. So hurry into your Dodge dealer today. During the Dodge model year-end clearance, get 0% financing for 60 months on all 2006 Dodge trucks. Hurry, this offer ends soon.
Tonight's Western Kentucky-Georgia basketball game is brought to you by Dodge. Western Kentucky got as close as one. Georgia then stretched it to 10, and now Western Kentucky with back-to-back baskets make it a four-point game. Boy, the shooting percentages have gone downhill here in the second half.
Yeah, particularly for the Bulldogs. Look at that. 20% drop, 30% drop. Let's go back and take a look at that dunk by Evans just before we went to break with the left hand reaching back. Nobody for Georgia there to block him off of the glass, and he took full advantage of it.
Evans has 4 points, six rebounds, but he'll take a seat on that Western Kentucky bench. And Emerson getting it done underneath. Count the basket.
I was watching Brazelton go up there to Emerson. He was going to chest bump him. I thought Emerson was going to knock him in the third row.
Emerson tonight with 14 points. One out of two at the stripe. Can't convert the three-point play, but it's a four-point Bulldog lead.
Well, every time Georgia is on the verge of putting Western Kentucky away, they battle back.
Gaines stutter step inside. He's fouled. Free throws on the way. Emerson will pick up that foul. That'll be his third.
Well, Emerson was at a disadvantage that time simply because Gaines, when he came off of that screen, hung Brazelton up on that screen. And usually when a big guy gets a foul underneath against somebody else, it means he's come off and left his man to help. And that's exactly what happened that time to Emerson.
Gaines misses the front end. Gaines last year shot 60% from the free throw stripe, went 122 times.
It's the one part of his game he really needs to work on.
At his career high against Tennessee last year when he poured in 23. Double figures in 19 contests. He has now started 59 consecutive games for the Bulldogs. Here's Courtney Lee. He's been held in check for the most part tonight. Although you look down, he's got 14.
I tell you, Stooks did as much as he could do defensively. He finally backed him down low enough and then spun back out for that little eight-footer in front of the rim.
Here's Gaines, top of the key. Takes it inside, working on Emerson. He got too far underneath the rim. Emerson, his pass knocked away. Here come the Dogs. Stoops.
Turnovers are killing Western Kentucky.
Bliss underneath to Gaines. His layup is good. Dave Bliss, give him the assist.
Yeah, pretty good team basketball that time. He kind of presented himself as a screen after he dealt the ball off. Nobody could get around him.
Brazelton quickly back the other way. Misses, but gets the ball back. Lee, free throw line, off the iron, no good. And a foul underneath on either Newman or Bliss. Who will it be on? And that will go against Steve Newman with a push underneath against Mike Walker.
Take a look again. You'll see right here. Look at Bliss. He kind of hands it off and yeah. He spreads those arms out. Said, nope, nobody's getting near my man over there.
The human wall. Dave Bliss, who's battled so many injuries last year, is back. Just he couldn't even practice. He would walk around, walk throughs, and play, try to give the coach 15, 17 minutes a game. Dennis Felton says he's still hurting, but much better than he was a year ago. Can actually practice a couple times a week now.
Good trap by Western Kentucky. Good pass by Mercer.
Underneath to Stoops. Count the basket, foul on Emerson. That's his fourth.
Dave, that's where you've got to recognize where you are on the floor and what the situation is for you personally. Mercer, knowing he had three fouls, should never have gotten in a position to commit that fourth foul as badly as they need him. Good trapping by Western Kentucky at the end right there. He had nowhere to go. It was going to be a layup for Levi Stoops. Let him get the 2 points. Don't draw the fourth foul.
Get out of there. Especially with the kind of night Emerson's been having. Emerson with 14 points, 6 rebounds. He's 5 out of 7 from the floor. He also has 3 threes. 3-point play completed by Levi Stoops. Stoops now with 10. Singleton inside. Oh, what a shot over the 7-footer Singleton.
What a move by Brazelton.
Here's Gaines. Stoops with 999 career points. Give him 1,001. Back the other way, Western Kentucky. Lee kicks it back out. Shot blocked by Newman. Into the hands of Mercer. He dribbles through three red jerseys. No look to Gaines. He's fouled. Free throws on the way.
Oh, they're going to call it intentional.
Unabated to the basket, and the player was deemed defenseless. That'll be 2 shots and the basketball. But Levi Stoops goes over 1,000 career points. And Georgia has the 8-point lead.
You see what's there. We see what's next. We all have a big picture. What's yours? Regions. That's the power of everyday confidence.
I am so into you. I can't think of nothing else. I am so into you.
Roger, it's 2:00 in the morning.
Sauce. It's the bottle with the cowboy.
Also try Texas Pete Buffalo Wing Sauce.
4,800 student athletes. 2,200 named to academic honor roll. 17 named first team academic All-American. 12 universities. One mission. The Southeastern Conference, equipping tomorrow's leaders today.
You see Rick Crawford checking the officials' replay monitor, and they actually indicated the basket went down, but he missed the shot, making it an 8-point game, but it's really just a 6-point game. And here's the intentional foul that will send Sunday out of Gaines to the free throw line.
Well, the call was correct in the intentional foul, and obviously the referees got the call right as it did not go in, but they will get the 2 free throws. They will get the ball.
Levi Stoops over 1,000 career points, the 36th player in Georgia history to produce such numbers. 13 points tonight. eerily quiet in the building.
It's their man shooting free throws.
But apparently the score was correct, 62-54. Before the free throws, one out of two for Sundiata Gaines. So apparently they never changed the score, even though they said the basket was good on the intentional foul. So we are where we are supposed to be, 63-54. If that makes sense, congratulations.
Does to me. Simply an intentional foul, and they shot the free throws, and now they get the ball.
Bulldogs, 32 points off the bench.
1-4 set. Good pass inside to Singleton.
Stoops fires. No good. Rebound to Collier. For Ely, with 16 in the game to lead Western Kentucky. He'll need to get hot down the stretch as it's a 9-point lead for the Dogs. Brazelton guarded by Stoops, nowhere to go, and a hold against Levi Stoops.
You know, Stoops is really putting a lot of pressure on Brazelton. I mean, he's got ball on defense as good as anybody out there right now. And Brazelton's having great difficulty getting around him. I tell you, Stoops is some kind of good defender. I mean, he can get down and guard you. It's a real challenge for him. I mean, you get a guy like this who has a reputation coming out of junior college, a junior college All-American, can handle the ball. And Stoops is right there to give him everything he wants, making it very tough on him to get inside.
Brazelton to the free throw line. It's an 8-point game, just over 7 minutes to go. This Western Kentucky club lost 18 and a half points when Anthony Winchester departed school, the Sun Belt Player of the Year last year. They also lost Elgrace Wilborn, who came in with 8.5 points and 6 rebounds. They lost quite a bit of offensive production.
Tell you one thing, though, their freshmen are a year older now, and they're a lot more mature. And having Brazelton around has made a big difference.
Stoops gave up the three.
Good move by Mercer.
Spins off the iron.
Boy, he couldn't get that one to go in. Did everything but get the shot.
Evans, the rebound off to Brazelton. Lee forced a shot up. Humphrey might have gotten a piece of it. And I know Singleton got a piece of that one.
Stand your ground when you're 7 feet tall.
I did the Georgia Tech game a year ago and watched the big fella Singleton swat away 6 Yellow Jacket shots in about 10 minutes of action. He's got the potential. Lost the handle. And the follow is up and good.
If you lose the handle and it's 8 feet up in the air, it's a pretty good thing because usually you're the only guy around up there.
But then Evans comes back right on the 7-footer and gets it to go down. Just as Georgia matches their biggest lead of the game, Western Kentucky responds.
Well, good block there by Singleton. Then on the other end, after he makes a defensive play, see, you lose it at 8 feet. There's nobody up there that you have to worry about. Just go up there and grab it and put it back in. You know, one of the things that I think that Dennis Felton was concerned about with Singleton was his conditioning, too. He was afraid he was not going to be able to play long moments in a game. And if you notice tonight, he has substituted for him freely. He plays 4, 5, maybe 6 minutes, and then he's out. And they'll get Bliss in there, or they'll get Jackson in there to give him a little bit of a blow. He's getting stronger, and he's getting better. And as you said in the first half, he is a work in progress.
Back to a 7-point game as we go under 6 minutes. Western Kentucky came in here 2 years ago and beat this Georgia team 71-61. Georgia won in Western Kentucky last year. Joyner picks up the foul. That'll be his second.
It's Just watching Darren Horn over there, the coach of Western Kentucky. He reached down to get Daniel Emerson, then realized he had four fouls on him. He said, nope, you go back, you sit down. I'm going to wait a while before I put you back in there.
When do you go back to Emerson?
Pretty soon. I would say within the next minute. Maybe at the next break. Next TV break after that, he'll come back in. He needs him on the floor right now.
Brazelton off to Courtney Lee. Big hop step and a push. Got helped on the big hop step by Levi Stukes. And for Stukes, that'll be his second.
Stukes has done a pretty good job containing him in the second half. Lee has not been able to go off like he did in the first half.
Yeah, we haven't seen a whole lot of Terrence Woodbury here in the second half. He played a lot of minutes in the first half. It's been really Levi Stukes going most of the way, along with Mike Mercer.
Sometimes you need that defensive stopper. And I think Stukes is maybe a little bit better at that than Woodbury. Not to say Woodbury is a weak defensive player. I think he's very good. Just think Stukes is a little bit quicker. Western Kentucky now in his own defense, a 1-3-1. We're not trapping out of it as they were earlier.
Stukes out of the corner. No good. Humphrey skies for the rebound. Put back. Left it short. And a foul underneath against Dave Bliss. That'll be his fourth. And the parade to the free throw line continues. Western Kentucky in the bonus the rest of the way. Evans averaged 25 and a half points, 11 rebounds, 4 blocks as a high school senior in Arkansas. Dave Bliss goes to the bench. Albert Jackson checks back in.
I was talking to the staff at Western Kentucky yesterday at the shoot around, and they were telling me Jeremy Evans has missed 8 days of practice. He had a concussion, and then he came back and had a mouth injury, and he couldn't practice. A young man, again, and I'll say it in the second half here, that the Western Kentucky people are very high on.
Humphrey, long three, in and out. Georgia's three-point shooting has been ineffective here in the second half. Courtney Lee, he misfires from behind the arc. Both these clubs were dead on from behind the arc in the first 20 minutes, but in the second half, they have gone cold from the perimeter. Mercer will line it up. That's no good. Up ahead to Lee. The run out and the layup.
How about the pass by Brazelton?
Western Kentucky, Larry, on an 8-0 run to pull back within two. Every time Georgia gets out to a 9 or 10 point lead, Western Kentucky reels them right back in. And this man, Courtney Lee, a big part of that plan. He's got 20.
Sunday nights only on FSN. Be there live for the first show that breaks down the new BCS standings. The official BCS rating show, exclusively on FSN. Find out who's moving up, who's moving out, and who's moving on towards a berth in a BCS bowl game. Get the numbers the instant they break. The official BCS rating show presented by KFC. Sunday, live on FSN. Totally Football on FSN. Your inside source for all pro and college gridiron news. Host Laura Oakman and our insiders break all the stories.
And I'm tired of being quiet.
We'll take you inside the huddle. And behind the scenes.
If that's as good as we can play, so be it.
For all the pigskin action. Totally Football. Tomorrow on FSN.
The show that has the sports world buzzing. The FSN final score.
He'll unload, he scores! What a shot! It's the only national show that gives you nothing but wall-to-wall highlights.
Yeah, baby!
No fluff. No filler. Just all the action that's lighting up the sports world from coast to coast. The FSN Final Score, presented by DirecTV.
The Kentucky Wildcats host Miami of Ohio, Wednesday at 7 on FSN South.
Georgia leads by 2, 4:23 to go in the basketball game. And we told you about the cold shooting here in the second half. Both teams shot it very well from behind the arc in the first 20 minutes. But, Larry, what has gone on in the second half?
Well, you know, basketball is a game of adjustments. And that 15 minutes when you go in at halftime, you find out exactly what's hurting you. And obviously the three-point shooting was hurting both clubs. And their defenses have responded. And really, I think they challenged more beyond that arc. I think they backed off a little bit in that first half. But the second half, I have noticed that they're out there guarding a little bit beyond that three-point arc now.
Western Kentucky's 8-0 run has been accumulated over the last 90 seconds. Also, I think Brazelton being on the floor more in the second half probably has something to do with that.
Yeah, that's helped a great deal.
And the fact that Levi Stoops has been on the floor on Georgia's end more here in the second half. Evans with a good takeaway. A heady play to get it to Brazelton in the corner. There's a three. No good. Jackson the rebound.
Well, Collier had a good look at the basket, too.
Mike Mercer. Newman. Quick move over Evans.
He schooled Evans that time. I mean, there, when you get a guy like Newman, I mean, he's a senior. He knows what he's doing down inside.
Another missed three. Humphreys keeps his dribble alive. Off to Newman. It's now 3-on-1. How about the play from Brazelton? Knocked it away, and Courtney Lee has it.
Presence of mind of where you are on the floor and good quick hands.
Four-point Georgia lead. We approach 3 minutes to go. This game went down to the final seconds last year. Jackson swats it out of there. Collier spins into Jackson. Jackson blocks it again. And now a foul underneath against Sunday out of games.
I'll tell you what, I've got to give Western Kentucky credit, particularly Collier. He would not give up, and Jackson would not back down. Look at this. Carson, I'm coming back. Jackson says, all right, I'm here.
Timeout on the floor.
Gives me the feeling like she's not, like, listening to me.
Have you tried not saying, like, every other word?
What?
Remember your ski trip story?
Yeah.
I was, like, going down the hill, and, like, there was a crowd,
no,
and, like,
come on, that's
and
not
I was, like,
me.
Stuff either happens or it doesn't.
Holy.
Arson is not a victimless crime. Each year, arson crimes kill more than 500 Americans and injure many more. Arson causes about $2 billion in property damage each year. These losses are paid by all of us in the form of increased insurance premiums. How can you help? If you know of someone who is involved in an arson crime, call the Kentucky State Arson Task Force hotline at 1-800-27-ARSON. Callers may remain anonymous and may be eligible for a reward up to $1,000 if the information leads to an arrest or indictment. We need your help.
Some businesses read the headlines. Successful businesses make them. Get some insight to help you get there. Insight Business. Insight Business gives you a competitive edge with internet speeds as fast as 6 megs, up to 100 times faster than dial-up. But it's more than just fast internet. It's increased productivity, innovative services, and a better experience for your customers. We're the local provider, helping you grow the Bowling Green economy. And we're here to help with 24/7 technical support. Insight Business. Simple. Faster. Local.
Sarah on FSN.
The 2006 College Hoops Preview Series, Georgia Bulldogs, next on FSN South.
Georgia clinging to a four-point lead, 2:57 to go in the game. Look at the block shots.
Wow. Well, Dale, it helps when you've got big guys down inside like that. Albert Jackson leads the block parade right now. He has three.
Humphrey's got a couple. Singleton has a couple. Steve Newman also with two. A far cry from the Georgia interior play of the past few years.
Dude, that's going to present a real hurdle for a lot of teams playing them this year. What do we do? We're not, you know, if you can't make the ball on the outside, you try to go in there, they're going to be waiting on you.
However, Georgia still getting out rebounded. It's 33-30 in that department. Georgia last year was minus two in that department.
Collier misses both. Wow.
Western Kentucky, Larry, 13 out of 21 from the line with 22 turnovers.
That's a bad combination. Oh, Jackson's got, he's got to get the ball down inside. Good pass.
Oh, right through the hands of Bliss. Good recognition by Jackson. Now here comes Collier. He's guarded by Humphrey. A reprieve for the Hilltoppers. Gaines nearly takes it away. 24 on the shot clock.
Okay, Western Kentucky has had their chances here in the last 3 minutes to really take advantage of this game. Missed free throws, missed open shot opportunities, and Georgia's been giving them chances to do what they want to do, is to win this game, but they just haven't been able to respond.
30-second timeout taken by Western Kentucky with 2:20 to go. You know, it's been kind of an ominous start to this season for Georgia, Larry. They've had to go without one of their most likable, enjoyable characters on their basketball team the past couple of years, and Kevin Brophy, who died in July in a car accident. And Georgia celebrating the life of Kevin Brophy this year by wearing a patch. Do it for Broph. A comment made by Kevin's father in memorial service. Told the Georgia players, do it this year for Broph.
Well, they had a very moving tribute before the game here on their board. They showed pictures of him, and it's just a life cut too short too quickly.
He will be remembered for a long, 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 long time here in Athens. Courtney Lee knocks down the little turnaround off the glass. 22 for Courtney, and it's a two-point game. Here's Gaines. Humphrey thought about the three. Mercer. Gaines. Through the hands of Jackson, it'll be Western Kentucky basketball. And for Georgia, that's 19 turnovers tonight.
Let's go back and watch Courtney Lee again. This time with his back to the basket with a spin move off of the glass.
We've seen it all tonight, haven't we?
Everything from him. What's that, 22 for him?
22 tonight. 8 out of 14 from the floor. Brazelton ties it up at 67.
Dave, how about his second half performance? I mean, he has been terrific.
A dozen in the game for Brazelton. The last tie was at 5-5. Western Kentucky has never led.
Georgia needs a good shot now. They've got to get a good look at the basket.
Humphrey.
Another turnover?
That
is
the third turnover that Georgia has gone to the baseline, tried to pass into the paint. It's gone through everybody. And Western Kentucky has a chance to take the lead.
Watch this turnover. This one is crucial. I mean, you've got the basketball in good position. Humphrey tries to get it to the other side. Goes right by Mercer.
65 seconds to play. Here's Courtney Lee. Big screen from Emerson, and Lee threw it away.
Well, it's a parade of turnovers right now. This is not what you want to do in crunch time.
Oh, what a screen.
Oh, what a screen that was by Emerson. No way Collier could reach back and get that pass.
Newman off to the senior Levi Stoops. Mike Mercer in the corner, guarded by Collier. Here's Humphrey. Shot clock goes under 10. It's 7 on the shot clock. Humphrey needs to do something in a hurry. Blocked by Courtney Lee. pass underneath. Foul shots on the way for the Hilltoppers.
How about Courtney Lee? You know, when we started this show tonight, before the game, I said, this is the guy, if you drew up a blueprint of a player of 6'5 as a wing player, this is the guy you want to have. Look at that defensive block. That's a block about 30 feet from the basket. A great pass. Almost the basket, and Western Kentucky has a chance for a couple of free throws and the lead.
Larry, this went halfway down the cylinder and spun out.
Can't say enough about the play of Courtney Lee tonight. I mean, he is showing us everything on both ends of the floor.
Well, I will say this. Rarely do players meet the expectations of those around the program when an outsider comes in. Courtney Lee has met those expectations and then some from my point of view. Western Kentucky has outscored Georgia by 10 over the last 5.5 minutes.
Can you believe Georgia has only scored 2 points in the last 5 minutes and 30 seconds?
Larry, it was almost 5 minutes in the beginning of this half before they made their first field goal.
And I remember in the second half that they jumped out to two 10-point leads, and Western Kentucky battled back in both of them.
It only took 90 seconds to close the gap on the second 10-point lead Georgia had.
Well, there are a couple of combinations. One, obviously, is Lee, the way he's played. But the guy next to him right there, I think Tyrone Brazelton has had a big impact on this club, particularly the second half.
So Collier will step to the free throw line. And Courtney Lee with his 22 points. Couple of rebounds is our Lincoln Mercury player of the game. Collier knocks down the first one. It's their first lead, and it comes with 19.7 seconds to go in the game.
Wow.
Short, rebound Newman. Georgia can win it right here. The crowd comes to their feet. It's Mike Mercer, under 10, in the lane, spins, no good, rebound, and who else but Courtney Lee, and he's fouled. Seconds remaining.
I got to tell you, Mercer had a good look. I mean, he went right down the lane, right in front of the basket. He beat Brazelton deep and went right up over him. Brazelton backing off. There he's spun off the back of the rim and a good rebound, but by who? Of course, Courtney Lee.
I mean, Mike Mercer was right at the iron. Hard to argue with the shot. Had a clean look. Nobody was in his face. Just a little too strong. Timeout taken by Georgia. And the Georgia players look a little, it looks like they're sulking a little bit there. You know, he makes both of these free throws. It's still a three-point game.
Yeah, here's some of Courtney Lee. We've shown you what he's been able to do from long range. He's got a sweet touch from out there, but the 6'5 youngster can take it to the basket. Watch him right here. I mean, he floats down inside. It's a good rebound. Going to put his club up by three if he can make these two free throws. The question I've got is, what is Georgia going to do on the other end? If he makes both of them, the best three-point shooters they've got, obviously Billy Humphrey has been terrific from long range tonight. He's the guy I probably would look at. But they have struggled from beyond the three-point arc in the second half. They are 0 for 7.
Not a lot of confidence right now from behind the arc, but one guy who never lacks confidence is Billy Humphrey. Remember, in his opening game last weekend, Billy Humphrey against Southern hit 7 of 8 three-pointers. Tonight, Humphrey from behind the arc is 3 out of 8. So Courtney Lee to the free throw line. Another timeout, a 30-second timeout taken by Dennis Felton. They're going to stretch it to a full.
Yeah, they're going to take the 60. What that means is they can go over and sit down. You know, once a 30, you got to stay in the huddle and stand. I guess it takes 20 seconds to sit down.
You know,
by the time they finish,
right,
10 seconds, they got to get back on the floor.
Well, we're going to stretch our legs since it's a full. They can sit down. We're going to stand up and take a break. Back with the final 6.2 right after this. Western Kentucky up by one.
Every week, some will rise. Some will fall. And some will take the next step on the road to the BCS. BCS Breakdown on FSN. With previews of Saturday's biggest matchups and detailed analysis of the national championship picture. BCS. Contest Breakdown, Friday on FSN.
Western Kentucky leads by one. Back inside Stegman Coliseum, Dave Neal and Larry Conley. And this is how it went down on Georgia's last possession. Mike Mercer, perhaps their best all-around player, had a pretty good look from 7 feet. A little too strong. Courtney Lee with the rebound. Mike Mercer tonight, 5 out of 15 from the floor, 12 points. He does have 5 rebounds and 3 assists. But the story's been Georgia's shooting in the second half. They're down to 41%. After the first 20 minutes, they were at 53%. The big free throws, and this is Courtney Lee, the junior out of Indianapolis, Indiana. Shot 84% from the line a year ago. It's a two-point game. No timeouts left for the Bulldogs.
Plenty of time, though, to get it up for Georgia, to get it into front court, to get a shot.
Lee makes them both. Here's Mercer, guarded by Brazelton. Off to Humphrey. The three on the way. No good, and Western Kentucky wins it. A big win for Darren Horn and the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers.
And the series continues to be the visitors' dome. All three games have been won by the visitors on the other team's home court.
And very similar to what happened a year ago, Georgia wins in the closing seconds at Western Kentucky. This was the final attempt. Billy Humphrey, a fall-away three as time expires, and the Dogs will go down in defeat. They blew 2 10-point leads in the second half, and Western Kentucky battled and fought their way back. It may not have been pretty, but Western Kentucky and Darren Horn will get out of here, and they go to 2-0 on the early season. Impressive. The Sun Belt Conference better watch out.
Yeah, I think Darren Horn's got a pretty good club this year. I mean, the way they came in here and played tonight against a Georgia team that I think is going to still be pretty good in the Southeastern Conference, they really battled. They did it with a combination of good inside play, some good outside shooting, and I think some pretty good defense, particularly in the second half against Georgia for that 5 minutes and 30 seconds when they only allowed them to score 2 points.
All right, Western Kentucky. It was a good one here in Athens, 70-67. So our final score here, Western Kentucky by 3. Tune in tomorrow night for our next SEC men's basketball game as Georgetown takes on Vandy from Nashville. I'll see you there, 9 o'clock Eastern time. Stay tuned. The Georgia Basketball Preview Show is up next. So for Larry Conley and the rest of our crew, I'm Dave Neal saying so long, everybody. We will see you down the road.
The Georgia Bulldogs keep getting better, but so does the rest of the SEC East. So, what's it going to take for these Dogs to dominate? How about a couple of sharp shooting guards? And a coach who won't stop till his Dogs are on top. Hunker down, Bulldog Hoops fans. It's time for your 2006 University of Georgia basketball preview. From the campus of the University of Georgia in Athens, here's your host, Natalie Taylor.
The Georgia Bulldogs have come a long way in the 3 seasons under head coach Dennis Felton. And after a 2-year absence from postseason play, these Dogs are hungry to see a little action in March. So is this going to be the year? Here's Dave Neal with a preseason look at the 2006-2007 Bulldog team.
Well, thanks, Natalie. And when Dennis Felton took over the Georgia basketball program 3 years ago, he knew it would be an uphill struggle to get the Bulldogs back into the mix for an SEC championship. However, what he did not expect was to be playing with a roster of 7 freshmen and 4 sophomores in year 3. Now, despite that youthfulness and inexperience, the Dogs still found a way to win 15 games a season ago and perhaps laid the foundation for greater things to come in the process.
Going 15-15 isn't the kind of year most people would think is a positive accomplishment, but in Athens, it's more than that. After winning just 8 games the year before, the Dogs rolled off 7 straight wins while posting a 10-3 pre-SEC slate. Included in those 10 victories were triumphs over rivals Georgia Tech and Clemson. The excitement continued through early February when Georgia was 4-5 in league play after back-to-back wins over Alabama and Vanderbilt and still in the mix for some postseason hoops. However, that excitement would subside somewhat as they would drop 7 of their final 8 games to finish SEC play with a 5-11 record. Still, 3 games better than in 05.
We were one of the most improved teams in the country. And going into the latter stages of the season, we actually had a shot at making it to the postseason, which was probably more than anybody anticipated going into that year.
Point guard Sundiata Gaines filled up the stat sheet nearly every night. Starting all 30 games, he finished 3rd on the team in scoring, averaging 10.3 points. He led the club in rebounds with over 5 a game, while also taking top honors in assists and steals.
He has had to play a position, and the most challenging position, actually the point guard position, at this level after never having played it before. And so there was a lot of learning, a lot of growth for him to take on, and he has continued to grow.
Levi Stukes finished the year as the team's scoring leader with nearly 12 a game. With a horrible back problem all season, center Dave Bliss still managed to start every game and average 4.4 points and 3.4 rebounds. Georgia was in the middle of the SEC pack in scoring with over 70 a game, that despite finishing the year as the league's worst shooting team. Now, the biggest problem for the Bulldogs was on the defensive end of the floor, where they allowed 71 points a game as opponents torched the Nets at a 45% clip, both numbers ranking 11th in the SEC.
Well, the Dogs may have finally gotten their heads above water last year, finishing with a 15-15 record, but now it's time for them to start swimming. And for the ultra-competitive coach Dennis Felton, it won't be a minute too soon. Now, the coach must be smiling, knowing that he has all 5 starters returning, plus 2 big-time signees making their way to Athens. And now the questions are this. Will Georgia have enough talent to play with the big boys in the SEC, or will this be another lesson in patience for the Georgia basketball fans?
Coach Felton won't have to wait to see what his leader Levi Stukes can bring to the floor. This 6'2 guard is primed for a spectacular final year in Athens after finishing last season as the team's leading scorer while ranking 5th in the SEC in 3-point shooting, knocking down 40% of his shots.
Each year they kind of teach me more and more things that I can learn and need to learn in order to become, you know, one of the best shooters that I can become.
I think Levi Stukes is realizing that this is his last year to get it done. So, you know, you can see the urgency in him, and, you know, that carries on to the younger guys.
Stukes will be just one of many backcourt players expected to produce. Junior Sundiata Gaines returns at the point after leading the team in numerous statistical categories. But one he would like to get rid of is turnovers, where he averaged 2.5 a game. Cut down on those and remain aggressive on the boards, where he led the team, and he could be one of the most complete guards in the SEC.
Since he's been here and kind of growing side by side with him, you know, I've seen that he has took on a role as being our point guard and our floor leader.
The other perimeter players have all proven to be SEC quality guards. 6'4 Mike Mercer was outstanding, slashing to the basket, scoring 11 points a game, but hopes to improve on his 29% from behind the arc. After making the All-SEC freshman team, he spent the summer completely retooling his jump shot. Junior Channing Tony, who started 26 of 30 games, averaged 8.5 points per contest last year and is a solid threat from behind the arc. Sophomore Billy Humphrey rounds out this versatile group. As a rookie, he got off to a quick start, but like most freshmen, was inconsistent in SEC play. His 8.4 points a game proves he is more than capable of being a viable option on the offensive end of the floor.
They deserve all the praise, you know, they get. We've got some talented guards, you know, that can compete day in and day out with anybody in this league, and, you know, that's what helps us be successful.
The Bulldogs' biggest struggles were in the paint, where on most nights they were outmatched in size and strength. The Dogs were last in the SEC in rebounding margin. 6'10", 255-pound Dave Bliss is back for his 3rd year. A strong move to the basket from the top of the key. 7-foot Rashad Singleton showed his rawness last year, but did produce 43 blocks while playing just 11 minutes a game.
The fact that we will have a better presence close to the basket in each category, offensively, defensively, and rebounding the ball, it's going to make all of our players better.
two X factors for the Dogs could be 6'9 senior Steve Newman, who averaged 4 points and 2 rebounds, but can play either inside or out in Felton's system. 6'6 sophomore Terrence Woodbury showed he's more than ready to play in the SEC, averaging over 5 points a game, but injuries curtailed his year. If healthy, he's just one more option on the wing for the Dogs.
This year, it seems like we've got all the pieces we need to be successful. We've got more experience, more leadership. You know, everybody's been here another year. You know, so I don't see anywhere to go but up.
It took Dennis Felton a few years to take a dismantled Western Kentucky program to the NCAA tournament, which he did 3 consecutive years. And now in his 4th season as the Bulldogs head coach, he hopes this club is headed in the same direction. He will know a lot about his team early, as the non-conference schedule is very difficult, with games against the likes of Wisconsin, Wake Forest, Clemson, and Georgia Tech. And of course, it doesn't get much easier in the SEC. There will be a telling stretch of games in late January for this Bulldog program as they take on the likes of Alabama, Kentucky, LSU, and Tennessee in consecutive games. So, Natalie, there is certainly plenty of hope in Athens, but we must remember, this is still a very young Bulldog team.
Hey, thanks, Dave. Now, these Dogs may be young, but they've got as much talent as they've seen in a while here in Athens. Hey, stick around, Bulldog fans. We're just getting started from Athens. This is your 2006 Bulldog basketball preview.
Still to come, we'll visit with Georgia head coach Dennis Felton.
I do expect us to make another big step forward this year.
Plus, senior Levi Stooks tells us what's at stake for the Dogs this season. And we'll have a look at the Georgia team with our own expert, Barry Booker. So don't go away. The Georgia Bulldogs basketball preview is presented by Regions Bank, the official bank of the SEC.
There's more life in a Bell South house, because you can get singular wireless, unlimited long distance and local calling, high-speed internet and direct TV service coming together with one thing in mind: saving you money. Every month, guaranteed. On a family of services that's perfect for your family. Bring it all together and you'll get a nice warm feeling too. Only from Bell South. Call today.
A place to get away. We see a way you can retire there. We all have a big picture. What's yours? Regions. That's the power of everyday confidence.
Here's my Crystal story about the steamer challenge. We live about 3 minutes away from a Crystal's.
Hey guys.
You divide a steamer 12 on 12.
Really,
you got 3 minutes to eat all 12.
Go.
If you don't, you got to buy next time. So it gets pretty competitive. Hitting each other, punching each other, anything to mess up their rhythm.
Come on, man.
This guy could beat Kobayashi. He's kind of like a python. He can unlock his jaw.
Don't champion.
That's our Crystal story, and we dare you to top it.
Grizzlies basketball lives on FSN South.
Oh, baby, I love
the
it.
Versatile Eddie Jones and sharpshooter Mike Miller lead a youthful Memphis squad, bolstered by Grizzlies top draft pick Rudy Gay. All season long on FSN South.
The International Fight League. It's a hard-hitting semifinal showdown as the Dragons take on the Silverbacks in the world's first team fighting league. The International Fight League. Sunday, only on FSN.
Coming up on the next Around the South, the first place Hawks look to buck Milwaukee. We have got all the post-game coverage, plus getting a grip on the NBA's new basketballs. It's not as easy as you think. An Auburn linebacker who's not only a student athlete, but a teacher as well. And up close with the Thrashers, Ilya Kovalchuk. The man is fire on ice. On Around the South tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern Time.
Welcome back to the University of Georgia Basketball Preview Show. Once again, here's your host, Natalie Taylor.
The challenge Dennis Felton was faced with when he took on the job to rebuild Georgia basketball was downright daunting. To take on a program that had been nationally disgraced and slapped with NCAA probation and make it respectable again. But guess what? With 3 years under his belt, Coach Felton has this Bulldog team on the upswing. Our own Eddie Fogler recently sat down with Georgia's head coach to talk about the continued resurgence of Georgia basketball.
Coach, reflecting back, you're starting your fourth year now at the University of Georgia. You took over an incredibly difficult situation. Looking back at it, was it harder than you thought, A, and B, what was the toughest thing about taking over a program in such disarray?
Sure. You know, I really can't measure whether I feel like it was harder than I thought. I knew that we had a lot to deal with coming in. I knew that we were working from a serious deficit, and I knew that there were going to be many challenges and many obstacles along the way, and I knew that there were going to be some things that happened along the way that I didn't even know about coming in. So as they evolved, you know, I wasn't surprised.
How much did it affect your recruiting?
First of all, the first 20 to 30 minutes of every single conversation had to be spent explaining what happened at Georgia,
yourself,
exactly, and what does it mean for Georgia now, and trying to convince somebody that they should even consider Georgia under these circumstances at this time. Because, you know, we're recruiting guys that have a lot of options and can play at the highest level, you know, at other places in the SEC and beyond. And when you have those kinds of choices, you don't feel much like, you know, taking a risk and going someplace that has a lot of unanswered questions and has a lot of seemingly huge issues hanging over the program. So it affected recruiting. Recruiting was extremely difficult, as hard as I've ever had it anywhere at any time in my career.
You've built this program. You've made incremental progress each and every year. Last year was a nice jump up.
Yeah.
What do you expect this year? You got a lot of kids returning. What's the expectation for Dennis Felton?
I expect another nice jump up. I really do, because we have this is clearly our most complete team since I've been at Georgia, and our most balanced team. And what I mean by that is, you know, we now for the first time have some good ability and talent both inside and on the perimeter. And we have some decent experience. And you know, we did make a big move forward last year. And, you know, a big part of our move forward last year was based on that freshman class last year. And you know what guys tend to do between their freshman and sophomore year.
Key year jump.
All of our players have improved, but none more or as much as our guys who were freshmen last year, who are going to be sophomores for us this year, who, and you know, they all gained a lot of experience because they came in and played a lot of minutes because we needed them to. So based on all those things, I'm really excited about the possibilities this season.
Talk about your backcourt, your perimeter play. You've got a lot of depth in, on the perimeter. Stukes, Gaines, Mercer, and there's others. Yeah. How do you plan to use them all? Will you be a small team, a pressing team? Will you try to use your depth on the perimeter and get your best players on the court?
Well, we'll play three guards, you know, all the time. So, you know, there's an opportunity for all those guards to really contribute. I like playing depth. I like playing a lot of guys because we like to be really, really intense and tenacious and use a lot of energy every possession of the game. And when you play that hard, it's difficult to play, you know, 35 minutes every game. And we'll hopefully really make a lot of progress in becoming more of the defensive team I like to be. And that's just baseline to baseline. Very intense, challenging everything that you do, making to be disruptive, to create some offense. You know, we made some movement there last year where we were one of the best, one of the leading steals teams in the conference, but we weren't, we didn't combine that with a good enough job at making you miss shots.
Right.
And we've really got to get better at bringing our opponent's field goal percentage down. And our rebounding is going to impact that a lot, too, because there were many times where we did a good job defensively and made you miss, but we didn't finish the deal with the rebound.
Second shots.
Yeah, and second shots, just, you know, they're going to drive that field goal percentage up. And so I do expect us to make another big step forward this year.
All right, thanks, guys. You know, Coach Felton not just doing his part for the Bulldog Nation, but he's doing it for the entire nation as well. He's been on the USA basketball staff for both the national team trials and the Junior World Championships. Stay right where you are, Bulldog fans. We've still got more coming your way. This is your 2006 Georgia basketball preview.
Up next, the lowdown with Levi. You'll meet Georgia senior guard Levi Stooks. And still to come, basketball analyst Barry Booker gives us his take on these Bulldogs. So stay with us.
A crystal story you won't believe.
We're on our way to school. He gets hungry.
Oh, a crystal with mustard and ketchup.
The thing was, his fuel light was on.
So we pull into this oasis of crystals and gasoline. We're like, oh, let's get the crystals before we get the gas. And my truck just goes.
And we're forced to push it to the window.
We worked up an appetite doing that. We got our food. Put the gas on the car.
It's all good.
I got him to class.
And that's our crystal story. Big taste.
The Ford Fusion, now available in street clothes, starting under 18 grand. Bold moves at your local Ford dealer.
Listen and learn.
Internet hotel deals are disappearing everywhere. Everywhere but Priceline, where you can save up to 50% off other leading sites. When you name your own price, you pick your exact neighborhood and star level. Then we find the right hotel for you. The hotel gives us a huge discount, which we pass on to you.
Why book a hotel anywhere else?
Priceline, more ways to save.
Show period.
Thursday is the show that has everybody talking.
It's the one to tell you that.
Rumor, you're the one who's starting a rumor.
Next question.
It's Best Dams. Say what?
I'm the greatest of all time.
Dong, ding, dong.
I'm a bad man.
The greatest sound bites of all time.
I want your heart. I want to eat his children.
Packed into an hour of TV so crazy, you'll have to hear it to believe it. This week at 9 Eastern.
Welcome back to the 2006 University of Georgia basketball preview. I'm Natalie Taylor. What's one thing Coach Dennis Felton has not had in the past two seasons at Georgia? A senior starter. Well, that's most likely to change this year as the Dogs' leading returning scorer hits the hardwood for his final season as a Bulldog. Let's meet senior guard Levi Stooks.
Meet the Player is brought to you by Regions Bank, the official bank of the SEC.
Levi Jamal Stooks. I'm 6'1", 200 pounds. Shooting guard in the University of Georgia. I came to Georgia because in high school I didn't know about the SAT scores and I took my scores late. And Coach Felton, as well as all the other coaching staff, came and saw me play in a local league. And I did real well at that time. And they just been sticking by me throughout my whole high school career in my last year. The love that they showed me made me feel like this was the place for me. I felt it even more from the love from the fans and the community. The scouting report on me is a great shooter from the perimeter, good on the bar defender, a lot of energy, and just do whatever he got to do in order to win. The secret of being a great shooter is just always being prepared to shoot, have your whole body set and ready to shoot the ball. It's my last year. You know, it's another year for me to play this game that I love the most. Perimeter game this year would be, I think, a lot more open. You know, we got a lot more guys coming back. All of us came back with a whole new mentality, and, you know, we just ready to get this thing started. I don't know how front court will be this year because, you know, coming into practice, we don't know who who's going to be out there to play to start the game, but we know that we are going to give it our best and may the best man win. Can I say that again? I'm sorry. What's the question again? My favorite thing about Georgia is the fans. You know, coming into the school year, I knew the fans was going to be behind us a little bit more because we won a little bit more games last year and they're just ready to support us. So the fans is a big reason. My favorite thing about Coach Felton is when I shoot the ball from three and it might be a close game and he kick his foot back and lean back. As to say, he's shooting the three and watching it go in, and then finally when it go in, he, give himself a clap as well as myself, and, you know, he just wait for the next one to get shot up again. We lost a true buddy, a true teammate, some of our best friends. We lost our friend Kevin Brophy to a car accident. He's in a better place right now, and I know he's looking on our team and giving us all the strength that we need in order to go out and win. We just ready to get this started and show him that we haven't forgot about him, and we dedicated the whole year to him. Senior year, last chance. No hold back. See you soon.
You know, Coach Felton says he's seen a big change in his senior guard since Levi dedicated himself to becoming a fundamentally better shooter last season. Hey, stay with us, Bulldog fans. This is your 2006 Georgia basketball preview.
I'm Barry Booker, and after the break, I'm going to tell you why the Georgia Bulldogs are going to surprise some people in the SEC East this season.
You see what's there. We see what's next. We all have a big picture. What's yours? Regions. That's the power of everyday confidence.
Did you know that Bell South has a choice of speeds with fast access DSL?
So there's really no reason
to stick with dial-up.
If you just like to surf like me.
Or us, we just want a faster internet.
At a price you can afford.
Fast access DSL starts at
$24.95 a month.
And that's not an introductory price.
I have all the speed I need.
I have all the speed I need.
There's just no reason not to get fast access DSL, right?
Right.
You got that right.
Inspired by the most award-winning new car ever, Chrysler Aspen. The all-new 2007 Chrysler Aspen. Luxury, inspired by only the best.
High-speed internet now costs a whole lot less.
I like the sound of that.
Insight's ultra-fast high-speed internet offers faster downloads at a lower price.
Now you're talking.
Do more online faster. Download pictures, music, and videos in seconds. Even play games, search, bank, and shop faster.
Excellent. But how much?
Call 1-866-99-INSIGHT today, and you can add all that speed and all that fun for only $30 a month.
Now that's the internet I'm talking about.
I believe staying healthy is important.
I need to be responsible for myself and my family.
I want a place where I can learn from people like me.
Healthy Nation, the first independent network dedicated to healthy living. It's free, on demand, and easy to use. With explanations from real doctors, along with true life experiences from people just like you. Healthy Nation, always here, always independent. Available now on Channel 99, in the free spot.
FSN. The 2006 College Hoops Preview Series. Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets next on FSN South.
Welcome back to the University of Georgia Basketball Preview Show. Presented by Regions Bank, the official bank of the SEC. Once again, here's your host, Natalie Taylor.
Now it's time to hear what those experts are saying about this year's Bulldog team. Here's our own basketball analyst, Barry Booker, with his take on the 2006-2007 Georgia basketball team.
The 2007 Georgia Bulldogs, Dennis Felton's Dogs, have a chance to have a solid season this year as their young guards have gained some experience, gotten a little older, and become solid SEC players. Georgia, of course, these last couple of years have been led by Levi Stooks and Sundiata Gaines at the perimeter positions, and those guys have been joined by Channing Tony, Terrence Woodbury, some really solid young players along the perimeter that can score. Georgia's top four or five scorers last season were perimeter players, and the key for them this year will also be getting those young guys involved, getting the perimeter players to score and put up points for the Dogs. And last season, Georgia lost seven of their last eight games. They tried to play a more up-tempo style, but they really just didn't have the personnel to do it. Their inside players weren't good enough and athletic enough to switch ends of the court and play at that faster pace that Coach Felton wanted to play at coming down the stretch last season. But this year, with the addition of Brown, a junior college transfer, and also Rashad Singleton, has worked hard over the summer, has developed, and will be a good player for Georgia throughout his career. If those guys can come along, and also I think for Georgia, if they can play smaller, if they can have Terrence Woodbury playing the power forward position along with their other solid guards, get their best five players on the court, I think they have a chance to really compete in the SEC and may surprise a lot of people and jump up and compete for second place in the SEC East and maybe make an NCAA tournament run. I think more likely for Georgia, they have a solid year, over 500. They'll make the NIT, have some postseason play for the first time in several years, and have a decent club this year.
Well, that'll do it from the campus of the University of Georgia. For Eddie Fogler, Barry Booker, and Dave Neal, I'm Natalie Taylor, and thanks for watching the 2006 Georgia Basketball Preview.
Be there live for the first show that breaks down the new BCS standings, the official BCS rating show presented by KFC. Sunday, live on FSN.
When it comes to subpar seasons, Paul Hewitt has had it, which means it's time for Tech to get the buzz back in their sting. With the trio of talented juniors returning, things are looking fat on the flats. Can the Jackets jump back up to elite status in the ACC? Let's find out as we preview the 2006-2007 Georgia Tech basketball team. From the campus of Georgia Tech in Atlanta, here's your host, Heather Catlin.
Unacceptable. That's the one-word reaction that Coach Paul Hewitt had for his Georgia Tech team's uncharacteristically poor showing in the ACC last season. So will this year be more acceptable to Coach Hewitt? Here's Jen Hildreth to set the stage as we preview this year's Georgia Tech basketball team.
Thanks, Heather. You know, it seems like a long time ago that Georgia Tech went to the Final Four and played for the national championship. But the truth is that these Yellow Jackets are just two seasons removed from that 2004 title game. And while this year's team may be closer to that kind of championship contender caliber, this much is crucial. Paul Hewitt's squad is going to have to overcome many of the mental mistakes that marred the Jackets' play last season. Coach Hewitt knew he was going to have an experience to deal with on last year's team. What he didn't know was that he'd also have to find a way to rekindle his players' competitive spirit. After finishing a dismal 11-17, the program's worst record since 1997, Hewitt lamented his team's lack of focus and inability to finish out games. The Yellow Jackets managed just 4 wins in ACC play, losing 8 in a row and 11 of 12 during one stretch. The young team, which had lost 5 seniors and 3-year starting point guard Jared Jack from the previous season, struggled to find its identity.
Last year was very embarrassing, disappointment. We had a chance to do some good things last year, but unfortunately we didn't. Not to make any excuses, we just didn't get it done.
It was really tough as a team to you know, really pinpoint it right then. But, you know, really looking back on the season, we really felt like it was more of a mental toughness thing. And that kind of played on not being in shape physically as far as eating right and getting the right amount of rest or, you know, really taking care of our bodies in the offseason.
There was a clear lack of leadership and just one player on the roster who could claim any starting experience at all, 6'9 senior forward Theotis Tarver. The one sure strength that emerged was sharpshooting sophomore Anthony Morrow, who led the team in scoring at 16 points a game and led the ACC in three-point field goal percentage. Sophomore forward Rashawn Dickey stepped up offensively and was second on the team in scoring, but both he and fellow front court mate Jeremy Smith were criticized for their erratic efforts on defense.
We got to stop our opponents from scoring a lot of points. I think that's one thing that hurt us down the stretch. I mean, we'll be up the whole game winning, and then the last 5 minutes, the teams will come back. So if we can get back to being a defensive-minded team and shutting down our opponent, that'll give us chances to get out in transition and score a lot of buckets, because we have a lot of guys that can put the ball in the hole. We got a lot of guys on the perimeter. We have Rashawn Dickey down low, along with Jeremy Smith, that can put numbers up. But the only way that you're going to get opportunities to score is that you got to stop your opponent.
So the good news is that Georgia Tech returns 4 starters and 6 of their top 7 scorers. The bad news is that this is turnover from a team that finished 10th in the ACC. So they've still got a lot of work to do, but Georgia Tech should be bolstered by a quartet of newcomers that includes 2 McDonald's All-Americans. The Tech offense should be in good shape as a trio of juniors return to lead the way. None is more important than shooting guard Anthony Morrow, though he may be a little slow to get into form after sitting out much of the preseason with a stress fracture in his back. Joining Morrow are classmates Rashawn Dickey, second on the team in scoring and rebounding last season, and leading rebounder Jeremy Smith. There appears to be plenty of depth in the front court, where Smith and Dickey should be challenged by several talented freshmen, including McDonald's All-American Thaddeus Young. Young at 6'8 is also skilled enough to play in the perimeter, and finding out how and where he fits into the lineup will be a big key for Tech.
Thaddeus is great. He's great. He's very long. He can play multiple positions. He can even guard a big man. I love him being here.
In the backcourt, the Yellow Jackets' leader in assists last season, Zam Frederick, has transferred to South Carolina. But that may be a moot point, as one of the top-rated prep point guards in the country appears ready to jump in and run the show. Javaris Crittenden, a local product from Atlanta and another McDonald's All-American, is already being talked up as the next in a long line of great point guards at Georgia Tech.
Javaris, I mean, he's a point guard. He's going to have to step up and be a leader out there on the court. You wouldn't find that often in a freshman, but he's taking that role, and he's also very humble. All of the freshmen are very humble and coachable kids, and I love them. They fitting right in with all of the returning guys, the junior class, and then also myself.
Number one, I really like them as people and as kids. They're great kids. They're easy to talk to, easy to get along with, very coachable. On the court, they just do some outrageous things, you know. You know, they can really, really play. You know, Thaddeus is very athletic. Javaris as well, you know, he's a great floor leader. And, you know, they're really going to help us, and they really have the right mentality right now.
Sophomore Lewis Clinch, who came on at the end of last season and earned ACC All-Freshman honors, could be a valuable weapon if he becomes more consistent. Clinch was 3rd amongst ACC freshmen in scoring at just under 9 points a game, and he averaged 13.4 points, 4 rebounds, and 3.2 assists over the final 5 games of last season. Overall, the Jackets have a lot of positives to build on, but they will be tested early when they travel out to Hawaii for the Maui Invitational. There they'll open up against Purdue and then will face either Memphis or Oklahoma, both 2006 NCAA tournament teams in the second round. Then mixed in with the always difficult ACC slate is an early February matchup against UConn in the Georgia Dome, site of this season's Final Four. Heather?
Thanks, Jen. Might be a long shot, but Georgia Tech would like nothing more than to head to the Final Four in their hometown. Well, we're just getting started here in Atlanta, so stick around. This is your 2006 Georgia Tech basketball preview.
Still to come, we'll visit with Georgia Tech head coach Paul Hewitt.
I thought at the end of games last year, whether it's through immaturity, bad coaching, bad conditioning, we didn't finish games off.
Plus, why does Anthony Morrow have the Tech faithful buzzing? And our expert analyst Mike Jaminski breaks down the Yellow Jackets. So stick around. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets basketball preview is presented by RBC Centura, the official bank of the ACC.
Ever notice how free things always seem to come at a price? Well, RBC Centura sees differently, with free checking that's truly free. No fees, no minimum balance, and no direct deposit required. Plus, if you open an account now, you'll also receive our debit rewards program that earns you points toward free gifts. It's a material world. Enjoy it freely. Call 1-800-CENTURA or visit your local banking center.
Here's a little story about Crystal Newing.
We all meet at Crystal.
Get like 30 steamer packs. Heading down to the river.
Just like a caravan.
We get a big inner tube. Put the cooler in the inner tube.
Gotta protect the crystals at all costs.
Extra duct tape on the crystal.
Bunch of cord.
Throw like life jackets around it.
30 seconds after the canoes hit the water, they're all partying. They're dancing around.
Oh, he's partying. Then Jenny freaks out because she sees a snake. It's like a piece of rope that's just floating inside.
He was
runs.
Coming towards the boat.
It's all about crystals and friends and fun.
Did you know the Bell South has a choice of speeds with fast access DSL?
So there's really no reason.
There's really no reason to stick with dial-up.
If you just like to surf like me.
Or us, we just want a faster internet.
At a price you can afford.
Fast access DSL starts at
$24.95 a month.
And that's not an introductory price.
I have all the speed I need.
I have all the speed I need.
There's just no reason not to get fast access DSL. Right?
Right.
You got that right.
Nissan asks, what's your resolution? More power? Space? Capability? How about saving money during Nissan's national year-end sales event? Get $2,750 Nissan cash back or 1% financing on the Titan King Cab. Offers end November 30th. Get to your Nissan dealer now and resolve to save.
The show that has the sports world buzzing. The FSN Final Score.
He'll unload, he scores! What a shot!
It's the only national show that gives you nothing but wall-to-wall highlights.
Yeah, baby!
No fluff, no filler, just all the action that's lighting up the sports world from coast to coast. The FSN Final Score, presented by DirecTV.
Welcome back to the Georgia Tech Basketball Preview Show. Once again, here's your host, Heather Catlin.
Twice in the history of the Atlantic Coast Conference has a rookie coach been named Coach of the Year. The last time it happened, Coach Paul Hewitt in his first year at Georgia Tech in 2001. He led his team to the NCAA tournament and 3 years later to the Final Four and within one win of the national championship. So what does Coach Hewitt think of this team going into the season? Our own Dan Bonner recently sat down with Tech's head man to find out.
Paul, I know last season was a disappointment. Mm-hmm. And what is your approach this year? Not to try to avoid that, because that's just something that happens. Mm-hmm. But what's your approach this year, particularly given all the young guys that you have?
What quite happened last year? I don't remember, no.
Good. That's the approach. I like that approach. But what's your approach this year trying to blend all the young guys in to sort of get back to what Paul Hewitt, Georgia Tech basketball, at least has been to me, flexibility, toughness. What are you doing to get back there?
Well, we made some changes in the offseason in terms of how we condition. When I say offseason, more preseason.
our trainer Tim Hansen suggested that we might want to adjust some of the things we've done in the past because we were coming up with a lot of lower leg injuries, and you know, just really would take it out of us. You know, key players would get hurt. But with that said, we did more conditioning on the basketball court because I thought at end of games last year, whether it's through immaturity, bad coaching, bad conditioning, we didn't finish games off. We had a lot of times, we had a lot of opportunities where we could finish games off and gotten 5, 6, 7 more wins. And we didn't show the type of toughness that our team had been accustomed to showing when we had Muhammad and Elder and those guys. And I think we did some things in the offseason to help us get back to that level.
Now that you've started, given the conditioning and stuff, how is the health of your team? I know the health of your team last year was really an issue, and I know it's early, but how's the health looking?
So far, so good. Muhammad Fay, who's a redshirt freshman, he's ahead of schedule. He had surgery on his wrist, and he's about 3 weeks ahead of schedule. Anthony Morrow, he's feeling better. He has a stress fracture in his lower back, but we're proceeding with caution with him because it is a back injury. But overall, so far, so good.
Last year was difficult in a number of ways, obviously. Right. And one thing is your play at point guard was a little bit inconsistent. Mm-hmm. And now you have a very highly touted young man mm-hmm. coming in as a freshman. Mm-hmm. Not a new situation at Georgia Tech, but tell us about him a little bit.
Well, first, I don't know if our point guard play was inconsistent. I hope our whole team was inconsistent. You know? But Javaris Crittenden is a high-energy guy, plays it. A great deal of explosiveness and wants to be great, wants to be a great player. That's probably the best thing I can tell you about him. The thing he has to work on is that he's got to understand sometimes physical doesn't always beat mental. So I think thinking the game a little bit more is going to help him. But puts great pressure on the ball, plays the game at a tempo that we want to play at, which is up-tempo, and a very unselfish, gifted passer.
Evaluate your inside game. What are you expecting from your inside game this year?
We're very talented. We have two kids in Rashawn Dickey and Jeremy Smith, who, in my opinion, really come. They're the key to our basketball team. If they play around the basket the way they're capable of, then we have a chance to really be good if those new guys can fill in the gaps. And even some of the returning guys can fill in the gaps. But it's going to come down to playing at, a high level of energy, which is something that our teams have been always known to do. And just really sustaining that effort throughout the game. Rashawn and Jermis, I know they can do it. There have been times where they were up and down in that area, but so far in practice, I'm very pleased with what I see.
Looking at a lot of the preseason prognostications, and of course they end up being meaningless, but
absolutely.
people are talking a lot about how improved Georgia Tech will be, that there seems to be a higher level of expectation. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
It's a good thing to have high expectations. You know, every coach that's going to come in here will tell you that our expectations that we put on ourselves and our team are greater than anybody outside the program. But I think the expectations are warranted because we have five kids in Mario West, Anthony Morrow, Lewis Clinch, Rashawn Dickey, and Jeremy Smith, who are talented players who have been through this league. And then you add a Zach Peacock, a Muhammad Fay, Thaddeus Young, Javaris Crittenden, and you say, boy, you know, they got some pieces there. They got some guys that can play a little bit and guys who have been through it. DeAndre Bell started a couple of games last year and had some success. But what everybody's going to find out about this league this year is that it's almost impossible to predict what's going to happen because it's as deep as I've seen it since I've been in the league. And I hope people around the country can recognize that when we start beating each other up and we come out with a bunch of 8s and 8s and 9s and 7s, it doesn't mean we have bad teams. It means we have a great league.
And that really has been an issue at some times.
Yeah.
And I guess there's nothing really that as a coach you can do to address that.
Yeah.
It's why would that be? Why would the perception be that an Atlantic Coast Conference team that's 8s and 8s and 9s and 7s isn't worthy of the NCAA tournament?
Well, some of it might be self-inflicted that we have people who have been around this league since, you know, forever, for how long, and they're still hearkening back to 82 and 83 when maybe the three of the best players in all of college basketball resided in the ACC. And it's not like that anymore. The best players are going pro early, but for some reason everyone else gets a pass on it. But when it's an ACC team, it's like, well, the league is down. You know, Michael Jordan's not a junior, what do you mean? You know, Ralph Sampson's not a senior, what are you talking about? You know, but you know, when you look around college basketball, year in, year out, we're coming up with the top recruiting classes. When you look at the NBA draft, year in, year out, we have a high number of teams, high number of players coming out of all the teams in our league into the draft and being successful in pro. So if we're getting them on the front end and they're going into the NBA and having success, then we must be doing something right. I don't think we're all screwing them up once they're with us. So I think a little bit of it is like we got to get past that old, the league isn't what it used to be. Well, guess what? All of college basketball is not what it used to be because of the early departures. But when you compare us and you put us in context, we still are the best year in, year out.
Paul, thank you very much for your time and good luck to you.
All right.
Thanks, guys. Coach Hewitt obviously not standing pat after suffering the worst season in his 9-year career as a head coach. Some say that this year's Tech offense will resemble the teams that he coached at Siena, where he won 66 games in only 3 seasons. Well, we have a lot more coming up, so stay with us. This is your 2006 Georgia Tech basketball preview.
Up next, will Yellow Jackets sharpshooter Anthony Morrow sting the rest of the ACC? We'll meet the Tech senior guard. And later, expert analysis on the Yellow Jackets' chances from our Mike Jaminski. So stay with us.
There's more life in a Bell South house because you can get singular wireless, unlimited long distance and local calling, high-speed internet and DirecTV service coming together with one thing in mind, saving you money every month guaranteed on a family of services that's perfect for your family. Bring it all together and you'll get a nice warm feeling too. Only from Bell South. Call today.
The world's first four-door, five-passenger Wrangler. Wrangler Unlimited. A new species from Jeep.
Not all the energy for our fuel comes from oil on the ground. A lot of it comes from our people, who year in and year out put so much of their energy into everything they do. So you can be sure that when you put Valero gas into your tank, you're going to get a lot out of it. Valero, the energy to take you anywhere.
Who will rise? Who will fall? And who will take the next step on the road to the BCS? BCS Breakdown, Friday on FSN.
FSN South is your destination for Hurricanes hockey. This season, Carolina hits the ice with plans to keep the Stanley Cup in their sights.
It's a one-man show. Cam Ward shuts the door.
Hurricanes hockey, all season long on FSN South.
Coming up on the next Around the South, the first place Hawks look to buck Milwaukee. We have got all the post-game coverage, plus getting a grip on the NBA's new basketballs. It's not as easy as you think. An Auburn linebacker who's not only a student athlete, but a teacher as well. And up close with the Thrashers, Ilya Kovalchuk. The man is fire on ice. On Around the South tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern Time.
Welcome back to the 2006 Georgia Tech basketball preview. I'm Heather Catlin. He was one of the ACC's most dangerous jump shooters, leading Georgia Tech in scoring last season with 16 points a game. He's a guy that Coach Hewitt will be counting on not only for scoring, but leadership this season. Let's meet Georgia Tech senior Anthony Morrow.
Meet the Player is brought to you by RBC Centura, the official bank of the ACC.
Anthony Morrow, shooting guard, 6'6", 218, Georgia Tech. I came to Georgia Tech because it's a great school. Coach Hewitt is a good coach, and my mom liked the school. I'm a great three-point shooter because I get in the gym and I love to shoot the ball. When the ball leaves my hand, I know it's going in every time. When the ball goes through the net,
I don't know what to say to that. When the ball goes through the net, I look at the person that was guarding in the eye. On a scale from 1 to 10, my intensity is 100. Last year, we struggled a little bit. This year, we're going to prove everybody wrong and come back strong. Our playing game this year would be ridiculous because we got a lot of athletes, a lot of people that can score. Our front court game this year would be nasty. We got Rashawn Dickey and Jeremy's man, Child Smith. You're not going to like me. You're going to be mad. My favorite thing about Georgia Tech is the swarm because they're all over the court. And I love them. The swarm is the student section right by the baskets. I love the swarm because they scream, they're wild, and they really let us know they love us. My favorite thing about Coach Hewitt is his antics in practice. Not going to the NCAA tournament was, wait, I don't even know what to say to this crowd. Not going to the NCAA tournament.